Western. Welcome to Plaster on an 80-degree October day. I'm Don West, joined by Dan Lucy, Daniel Shedd, our pregame host, and Megan Rice on the sidelines today. Big opportunity for the Bears today, Dan, for homecoming. Excitement in the air.
Yeah, Missouri State taking on Western Illinois for the fifth time for homecoming, and the Bears have beaten the Leathernecks three of the four times they've played. Also, Missouri State has won the last five games played against Western Illinois.
It looks like a great matchup today, too. Both teams 1-1 in the Missouri Valley Football Conference.
So last time that the Bears played here, they played the best team in the Valley. Now they're going to play some of the best players. The best rusher, the best receiver, and two of the best defenders in the league will be on the Plaster Stadium field today.
Homecoming 2016 at Missouri State University. And we're glad to bring it to you today on KOZL. All the action comes your way when we come back right after this.
Fumble this season. And for Western, how about look to Lenore? The senior Lance Lenore can change the game with his hands and his feet. Already two 200-yard receiving games in Missouri State's secondary is very young and will be tested today. Eat the clock. Western Illinois wants to win the time possession war, and they can do that with a balanced attack. They're third in the Valley and holding the ball. Last week, they had the ball 10 minutes longer than Indiana State and forced mistakes. The Leathernecks will try to get the Bears to commit penalties and turn the ball over. Missouri State averaging close to 60 yards in penalties this season, and that could be enough to tip the scales. And again, we've got an injury report. Malik Earl will not play for the Bears because of a foot injury, and we'll have more from that in a couple of seconds
here. And four turnovers last week against North Dakota State for the Bears, and they just can't let that happen today. Here's Luke Otto to kick off. Seven kickoffs last week against Indiana State. None of them returned. Five touchbacks, one kicked out of bounds, and one fair catch. The series led by Missouri State 17-15 with one tie, and the Bears have won five in a row.
And they got Deion Holloman back there getting ready to receive this kick. And there's a strong wind. We talked about it in the pregame. 18 miles an hour straight out of the south. So the way that I kick this ball, it could end up over at the McDonald Arena roof by the time this gets done.
And it blows off again, and so they'll bring somebody out to hold it now. Still a big crowd over there at Bearfest Village. Starting to fill into the stands here on the student side. We'll try once again to get it going. LaMarcus Stewart is back deep for Missouri State. And this one will be bombed to the back of the end zone and out to the 25 for the Missouri State Bears.
The 16th time this season that the Leatherbacks have had a touchback with the way that Otto can kick that ball.
Brody Lambert will lead the Missouri State offense out, the senior from Arlington, Texas. Lambert, 49 of 79 through the air, 461 yards, three touchdowns, and two interceptions. We'll see if the Bears' running game can kick it in a little better after that lackluster game against North Dakota State here a week ago. And it will go to Kalen Crowder on the first give.
Yeah, we talked about Malik Earl not being out there, Don. Only two wide receivers in that set for the Bears. You had LaMarcus Stewart and I think Zach Hoover on the near side here. And then there's Holloman out there.
Gain of just one, second and nine for Missouri State. Crowder, 47 carries for 276 and four touchdowns in the season. Lambert wants to throw, and it is incomplete, intended for Crowder right there. So third down coming up for the Bears. On the offensive line, Clanton, Turner, Schontz, Elifritz, and Prophet. The skill players with Lambert at quarterback. Randall, and we'll see probably not Malik Earl today, but Holloman, Hoover, and the rest, and that's a late change. Incomplete there. So
Holloman was double teamed, but the ball hit him right in the hands and he dropped the ball. So the Bears coming off the field, going to have to punt. And it's the first time since the K-State game that they've not been able to get a field goal or a touchdown on the first drive.
It's such a big difference without Malik Earl today.
He's got height. You know, you've got coming across the middle. He's got an extra 3 or 4 inches than some of the other guys have on the field. But that one, again, you can't put it on Lambert because it hit Holloman right in the hands.
Zach Drake, the punter for the Bears. Nearly a 41-yard average, and this one will roll dead at the 34-yard line.
And that's what you get from Zach Drake with that rugby kick. When he runs that way, it's not so much, you know, how much it goes through the air. It's when it hits the ground and then rolls, because he can get a good 15, 20, even 25 yards on the roll sometimes in that the way that those rugby kicks go.
And that was into the wind. Strong south wind today. Western Illinois heads out. Sean McGuire, sophomore from Franklin, Wisconsin. He will work under center. And to give on the first play to Steve McShane.
Dylan Cole there for the tackle.
McShane, 5 yards per carry, 587 total on the season. Offensive line anchored by Jacob Judd, preseason All-Missouri Valley Conference. And the rest of the starters for Western Illinois on the offensive side, McShane, Lenore, the Keys, Borsellino, a good receiver. It's a good offensive unit for Coach Charlie Fisher. And this one tipped. Look out. And it drops incomplete.
Like Cody Isbell got in there with that one. Got his big paw up in the air. And, boy, he had a big first quarter against North Dakota State as well. Big, strong presence in the middle of the defensive line for the Bears. 6'3", 240-pound junior out of Rogers, Arkansas.
He has really been something on defense on the line for Missouri State with Jones, Sutton, and Bratton. Linebackers and secondary, Dylan Cole, the anchor man on the defense for Missouri State.
Watch Lenore. He's on the top of this lineup right now. They got trips to the bottom, but Lenore's the lone guy on the top.
Third down for the Leathernecks. Across and complete. Joey Borsellino. This will be at the 45-yard line, enough for a Leatherneck first down.
We talked a lot about Lenore, but Borsellino, he has 2,000 yards receiving in his career, and he continues to march the seniors on either side for Western Illinois on the receiving corps.
So 2 minutes in, Leathernecks with the ball at their own 45. And the give goes to Steve McShane. Bears stack him up. Got maybe just one there.
McShane is plays baseball for the Leathernecks as well. Him along with Justin Fitzpatrick, a defensive back, play baseball for the Leathernecks and were in Springfield in March playing against the Missouri State Bears in a midweek game. Of course, they're not the same conference when it comes to baseball, but they are for football here.
Used to be in the old Mid-Continent Conference. Now on second and nine, the rollout and pass, it is caught. Adam Conrady, the tight end, and he'll have a first down in Missouri State territory at the 43.
This is the 12th ranked team in FCS, so again, this rugged Missouri Valley Conference as you march through, and usually 5 or 6 teams are in the top 25, and this Western Illinois team coming off a big win against Indiana State last week, come from behind, fourth quarter victory.
Just the third catch of the year for Adam Conrady. Had 2 for 18 coming in. Leathernecks moving the ball. To the air again. This one deflected and caught. And it's Lenore. After a deflection, it looked like from Curran Blamey.
Yeah, Blamey got his paw on it, but it went off of his hand right into the arms of the Western Illinois receiver. No pass rush at all. I mean, McGuire's got all day back there to look. But check out Blamey's paw gets up there. Boom! Taps it right into the hands of Lenore.
So his 39th catch of the year, over 600 receiving yards and 4 touchdowns. And Lenore in the process of rewriting the school and conference record books in receiving yards. Back to the ground now.
McShane just kind of took his time, let the play develop in front of him, and then just threaded his way through and close to another first down.
Western Illinois moving the ball.
It's Steck said before the game, talking about McShane, he says the kid doesn't really have a lot of speed, a lot of get up and speed, but what he has is elusiveness, and he can see the field, and you saw that in that last play. He kind of did a little stutter step at the line of scrimmage, found out what hole he was going to go through, and then got all the way down there for a gain of 8, and he gets it again.
McShane inside the 20, so Western Illinois into the Bears' red zone. They'll have a first down on the run by McShane. Ball at the 17 of Missouri State.
He's used to get, you know, hauling the mail as well. He had 207 yards on 28 attempts earlier this season against Eastern Illinois. So, you know, they throw the ball a lot to their talented receivers who have all of those career yards. But, you know, McShane runs the ball a lot as well.
Western Illinois' only loss was at South Dakota State 2 weeks ago. A bad loss, 52-14. Four in the win column, including an FBS win over Northern Illinois.
Oh, McGuire all day right up the middle of the field.
And all the way to the 3, maybe the 2-yard line for a first and goal.
The middle of the field was just wide open for him. He didn't take very long to decide to run. He saw it open and he just went for it.
Sean
McGuire drops back there, you can see, and then just takes it straight up the middle of the field.
Had rushed for a net of 54 yards coming into today, but has to take the hit in the rushing column on sacks, too. It's first and goal at the 3 for Western Illinois. And to give to McShane to the outside, to the corner, and in for the touchdown.
Just bounced it to the outside, took a look inside, saw that's where all the Bears were, and just kind of moved to the right and got it in there. McShane with the touchdown.
So Steve McShane to carry into the end zone, his 7th rushing touchdown of the season.
Bounced off of number 76 and just kind of used him as a, you know, pushed his way out toward the right-hand side and beat Dylan Cole to the pylon.
Extra point try for Nathan Knuffman. And it is up and good. Western Illinois out to a 7-0 lead, 9:42 to go in the first quarter at Plaster Stadium in Springfield.
Malik Earl injury. They said they didn't know anyone by the name of Malik Earl. Of course, they were joking about that, but here's what we do know about Earl. He was at practice on Tuesday. He's on the sideline in street clothes today. He does not have a boot, but it is an apparent foot injury. Behind him on the depth chart is Willis Chambers, and so Chambers and the other receivers will definitely have to step up because, well, Malik Earl is a big target for this offense. Guys?
Thanks, Megan.
Yeah, just like what she was saying, I mean, you could see that in the first drive, the one pass in that drive, and it went off of Holloman's hand. So Western Illinois takes the first drive down after the punt and scores, and we'll see what the Bears can do now on offense coming back the other way.
That took just 4:29 for Western Illinois.
We talk about the balance on this team, Don, and you saw that with a healthy McShane running the ball, and then when they needed to get the pass, they got it to a number of their receivers, both Lenore and Borsolano and everybody else.
Out to the 25 again. That'll happen all day, kicking to the north.
Right. Just a gale coming out of the south, going straight up. Those flags are just ripping straight over the north goalpost. And then Otto's got just a strong foot anyway. I mean, the kid just routinely puts it into the end zone and just takes that part of the game away for the Bears. So, got to be patient, look for it in the second, fourth quarters here. Now, the first time the Bears came out, they only had 2 receivers in the patterns. Now they've got 3 and then a tight end on the side here.
Fake to Crowder, swing it out. And to the... just clear of the 25-yard line to Eric Furmanek, a tight end. Eric Furmanek, 7 catches for 80 yards on the season for him.
And they'll bounce him all around. The first time he was got kind of held in and blocked a little bit, and then he went out wide now in this lineup.
2-yard gain. Kalen Crowder bumps off of the first wave and heads the other direction. And all the way to the 33.
Western Illinois' guy that tackled him it came down and just pulled him almost close to a first down.
Defensively, the Leathernecks, Winston Saunders, Nelson Belows on the defensive line. And the rest, watch for Moon at linebacker, along with the Taylor and Baxter amongst the leading tacklers for the Leathernecks.
And Baxter was the one that dragged down Crowder there.
This one out into no man's land, incomplete. Maybe a miscrossed signal there.
It looked like Holloman was open, but then the ball went, you know, way to the right of him.
So it is fourth down for the Bears. Zach Drake will come out to punt. Drake, last week, a 50-yard field goal against North Dakota State. The Bears had a 3-0 lead after a quarter and a half over the Bison, but then gave up 27 unanswered. He is punting for an average of 42.8.
Penalty flag on the ground.
Lenore.
Well, Lenore made that catch with two Bears all over him, but there is a flag, and it looks like I just saw the preliminary against Western Illinois.
Oh, that'd be a first down.
There you go.
Offside. Defense number 13. That 5-yard penalty results in a first down.
Bears in business.
That's good for the Bears. You know, I talked to some of the players on Monday, and we talked about this hot start that they get where they've gone down, and you know, Lambert said that they script out the first drive of the play. You know, you would think maybe the first 10 or 15 plays are kind of scripted out, and they're going to go by that script. Now, with the way that the last two possessions have gone, maybe you throw the script away and see what you can work on, but it'll be interesting to see what they do here. Now, keep in mind that script was all written up with number 17 playing a big part of it, and he's not out there right now.
Well, the Bears will resume at their own 38. Lambert, an option on a toss, and it comes out to Jason Randall, been the number two running back for Missouri State most of the season. 51 carries, 170 yards, and two touchdowns for Randall.
He's got a little bit of speed, and you can see it on the replay here as he gets the pitch, and he just kind of puts it in another gear to turn the corner and get past there. And he can also go out of the Wildcat for Missouri State. He's done that in three of the games they've played so far. Gives him an option. Coach Steck says it gives the defense something else to look at when it comes to Jason Randall, and the officials here talking about something.
Whistle from the side judge, Richard Townsend.
Will the game clock start on my signal, please?
So second and six. Bears with wins over Southwestern College on September 1st at Murray State and at Indiana State. Win in Sycamore Country 2 weeks ago was a nice statement in the Valley, 45-24. Indiana State was ranked 24th at the time. This one goes to Randall, and he is driven back.
Another penalty flag thrown from the back judge there.
Saunders.
Yeah, it's going to be chop block on Missouri State, it looks like.
That'll be a big one. Referee Matt Gallagher.
Personal foul. Chop block. Offense number 65 and number 66. 15-yard penalty. Still second down.
Well,
let's take a look at what happened. Riley Shantz, the senior for the Bears, the center. You can see him coming off against 95 and then him along with 62. The two of them are coming down.
Sam Ellifrit's part of it there, too. 66. Former conference lineman of the week. So two for the price of one there, at least, I guess.
They're only going to march you back once for that, not twice. got four receivers in the pattern now, and then you got Randall coming out of the backfield as well, and they go to him.
And complete to him for short yardage. It'll be third and somewhere around 20. Place it at the 24, so a two-yard gain. And third and 19 for the Bears, who keep it at the line here in the middle part of the first quarter.
This is the first time we're seeing Willis Chambers coming in, number six. Now, he's on the closest to our sideline receiver. He's the one that's going to have to try to replace Malik Earl. They've been going without that receiver so far in this game for Bears. They need a pass now.
And it's a safe run play to Randall. He got a little space, gets as far as the 38, 39-yard line, and that'll be it. So it'll be fourth and nine.
Nothing developing for the Bears so far in this first quarter.
Zach Drake will come out to punt again. He is a redshirt freshman from Lee Summit.
And he was not the punter for the Bears going into this season. Remember, the first punter messed his knee up at Murray State. A knee injury, and that's the end of the season for him. So Zach Drake was always the place kicker and the kickoff guy, and he's going to be assuming the punting chores as well now.
Out of bounds, and that was Brendan Withrow, who was injured. 6:27 to go, first quarter, here at Plaster Stadium on a sun-splashed October Saturday. 7-0, Western Illinois on top.
The Missouri Department of Conservation needs...
Homecoming, all the way back to 1921 from Missouri State, celebrating homecoming. And Steck, before the game, talking a little bit about, you know, he's a big Bruce Springsteen fan.
Yeah.
And he's like, you know, just like everybody comes back and reliving their glory days, as we're better than the team that's on the field. And when they played, we were better than that. So he says there's a little extra pressure on the guys to kind of prove that they can play the ball.
Pass you by them glory days.
Yeah, that's right.
Bears are 25-20 in homecoming games since 1971. Leathernecks start at their own 31. Little end-around handoff to Lenore, and he is taken out of bounds around the 40-yard line by Cameron Price, safety.
Kid can do it all, right?
Lenore on the run, just his second rushing play of the season. Lenore, preseason All-Valley.
A couple of big blocks there by his receiving teammates to get him to turn the corner.
He is in a chase with South Dakota State's Jake Weineke, who is still an active receiver for the Missouri Valley Football Conference all-time career receiving yardage record. McGuire back to the air and caught.
That was his second option, and they had to get the official out of the way. He got kind of knocked down a little bit, and that was good news for number 81 there.
And Tony Harper makes his fourth catch of the season, has one touchdown reception.
McGuire on the replay, you can see he looks one way, and it's not there. Then he comes back across to the second option, and then the official just knocks him down out of the way to get the ball. It's tough being out there if you're wearing stripes, right?
As always. First down at the 47 for Western Illinois. And given into the center of the line and into Bears territory. It's Jamie Gilmore running back.
He's a senior out of Florida, so they're giving McShane a little bit of a break there.
26 carries for 65 yards and a touchdown run for Gilmore. To the Missouri State 49, second and 5. Play fake. McGuire complete to Lenore. Oh, he hurdles a man and gets out of bounds at the 41.
He went right up and over Missouri State's Cameron Price. Cameron Price in the game against North Dakota State knocked down a pass in the end zone, but take a look at this. Lenore makes the catch, and then here's the senior over the redshirt freshman.
Lenore is one of six receivers in Missouri Valley Football Conference history with 3,000 receiving yards. He came into today at 3,320. At the 41 of the Bears, first and 10. Open receiver Gilmore shakes a defender, still going, and inside the 20.
Yeah, the Bears came with a rush, with a blitz on that play, and McGuire was able to get rid of it, and then the receiver was able to get past Matt Rush there defensively to pick up some extra yards and get the first down.
Sixth catch of the year for Gilmore. Western Illinois back into the Bears red zone after this, and he's wide open, shakes away from Matt Rush out of Hillcrest High School.
Dylan came up from behind to clean that up.
Give to Gilmore. Busy on this drive, and there's Dylan Cole. That may lose a yard. Cole, 10th all-time in Bears career tackles, starting the day with 365. Needed 4 to move up to 9th place and 14 for 8th place on the Bears career chart.
picked off a pass, and he's forced three fumbles so far in this season. And the Bears could use a turnover right now. They got to play straight here.
And the fake to Gilmore. On the move now, McGuire. He'll stretch it out. As far as the 16. And it'll be third and seven.
Blamey was able to just hang on with his fingertips on the Gilmore's feet, or McGuire's feet, to drag him down and save a touchdown there.
And from the 16, Western Illinois. Bears would like to at least hold for a field goal try here. Leathernecks have to get it to the 9. Step up, throw across the middle. Cole was there. He slings the receiver down, and it's incomplete.
And that's how you play defensive back if you're a linebacker. Cole did not care about the ball. He wasn't even looking for that. He just was going to make sure that he just wrestled the receiver down on the ground.
It was Tony Harper, the tight end.
Check this out. Just reached around, broke up the ball, and just threw him to the ground. Boom.
Nathan Knuffman out for a 33-yard field goal try. Last week against Indiana State, he had a 41-yard field goal in the fourth quarter. Then Western Illinois' defense made a fourth down stop with 30 seconds left to secure the Leathernecks' homecoming win. This is with the wind at his back, and he fires it into Bearfest Village, and good.
No problem. It's a low snap there, but he was able to get it through the uprights.
2:28 to go in the first quarter. Western Illinois adds three. The Leathernecks on top of the Bears, 10-0.
It's been all Western Illinois so far in this game. I mean, 119 yards of total offense for the Leathernecks against 25 for the Bears, and 8 first downs to 1, and time of possession, 8 minutes and 28 seconds of this first quarter. The Leathernecks have had the ball. We talked about that going in, just the fact that, you know, you can't, Missouri State can't score, but doesn't even have the ball in its hands, and that's what's happening. That, and the offense has struggled for Missouri State so far.
Luke Otto, the kick. And same result. All three have hit in the white right behind the end zone.
The wind is blowing back there, but Otto does have a very strong foot, and we'll see when they switch to the second quarter. But I don't know, maybe the Bears can keep him from even kicking off in the second quarter. Let's see what happens that way.
That'd be the idea anyway.
Exactly. But the Bears need to get something going rushing-wise. That was something that was that they had difficulty with against the Bison, and then here today. I mean, they were able to get it against Murray State. They ran a lot. They ran a lot against, obviously, Southwestern College. And even against Indiana State after that loss to K-State. So they got to try to refine that offensive gear.
Brody Lambert goes to work. This one is caught at the 30. And not much after the catch. But
Furmanek with the catch there out of the tight end position.
Eric Furmanek for a second catch. A gain of 6. Spin by Randall, and he is stuffed at the line of scrimmage.
And that was Brett Taylor, number 44, in there for Western Illinois. Not fooled by the crossing patterns and the ball going right inside to Jason Randall. And Taylor was there to make that stop.
Randall.
Spin there. Again, a solo tackle by Brett Taylor, his specialty.
Lambert. That space didn't stay open very long as he is torn down. J.J. Velos.
I like the idea, though, about him pulling it down and running. I think he needs to try to run a little bit more than he does because, you know, if he doesn't do anything running-wise, they're just not going to guard him.
There's a timeout called. 1:24 to go. And Western Illinois wants to maximize this time with the wind here.
Yep.
So the Bears are going to have to punt into the wind, and then Western Illinois will take it from there.
Well, strong defense coming in. I mean, they've stopped them all three times the Bears have had the ball in this quarter.
Leathernecks with non-conference wins early over Eastern Illinois in Charleston, 38-21. They hosted 17th-ranked Northern Arizona and won 34-20. And then an FBS win over Northern Illinois. Not the best FBS team, but still. Team of the higher level. And the rugby punt for Drake.
Nice punt.
Didn't get let it roll to the 35.
Didn't get as long of a roll, but it got some good hang time there.
36-yard punt, and Leathernecks will start at their own 35. 1:11 to go, first quarter. Dan, great to work with you for the first time in 6 years, man.
It's been a while. Did a little basketball with you guys and with you, and it's just it's fun to be up here doing Missouri State football.
Thanks to the folks at Color 10 for having me along today. I'm honored.
it's great. You're the voice of the Bears. You know, we got to have the television voice of the Bears out here.
I'm going to say I'm not Art Haynes.
You know, and he's sitting right to my right here, so that's fun for me to be sitting between the two of you. I'm honored today.
So great to be along on KOZL. Here's a deep ball to Lenore, an incomplete.
Lenore had his defenders beaten. Wide open field, but a little bit overthrown. Wind behind him. That wind again. You know, it helps the place kicker, but put a little bit of tailwind on that pass from McGuire. Yeah, getting the band back together.
That's
here.
Right.
That's right. That's right.
Second and 10 at the 35. McGuire steps up in a little space. He'll run. And to the 40 as he slams headlong into Alex Jones, the linebacker, and Jones is down.
Colby Isbell with the pressure there the first time to kind of flush McGuire out of the pocket. And that's Doug Jones hurt there? Tony Jones.
Let's confirm that, though. Yeah. I might have misread that. Jones on the tackle, and this is painful, whatever it is.
Taking a look at his left knee.
Coach Steck.
Second year at Missouri State, coming up to take a look at his injured player. Interesting, he says that, you know, we kind of talked a little bit about preparing for Western Illinois because, you know, you go through the Valley last season and he wasn't able to see the Leathernecks, and he said this was the first time in that he's been able to actually study their team as he's been looking at him in preparation for this game.
And it is E.J. Sutton.
He's the defensive tackle, 6'3", out of Schurz, Texas, a junior from Missouri State. And that play kind of, as Isbell went and put pressure on McGuire, he kind of moved out, kind of vacated the pocket to the left side, and then everything kind of shifts at that point. He's up and he's walking, though, and that's a good thing. Bears kind of were injury-free out of that North Dakota State game and pretty much have everybody in here except for, you know, Malik Earl at the beginning of this game.
It's shorts weather, if you don't mind the wind today.
Nice student crowd, though, over on the student side for homecoming. Come in from Bearfest Village and stick around for the game and homecoming. We're going to name a queen here at halftime. Name a king and queen.
Been a big day of athletics already. The Missouri State women's soccer team defeated Indiana State 3-1 today. Brooke Kronzinski had the hat trick with all three goals for the Bears. Men's soccer plays break tonight at 7 over at Betty and Bobby Allison South Stadium. McGuire to throw, deflected, and the lunge, but incomplete. Great effort. Cole was the closest Bear after the tip.
And that's Colby Isbell again, the second time in this game that he's been able to get his paws up in the air and knock down one of McGuire's passes. The first time, remember, it was caught by Lenore, and then this time Dylan Cole almost made the interception. You can see he gets his hands up in the air right there, and then Cole dies right out of his fingertips.
So the line of scrimmage, the 41, and Western Illinois has to punt. Again, Nathan Knuffman, senior from Pokesburg, Illinois. from the 15. Come back for the Bears for Deion Holloman, the kick returner extraordinaire.
Almost broke that one. We were trying to wait for something to happen with him and second special teams. He's been not able to return any kickoffs so far, but they got that punt. Nice little return there. Almost broke it. And how about the Missouri State Bears defense there? Western Illinois calling a timeout to try to use the win and get the ball and try to punch in another score before the end of this quarter, and the Bears were able to hold and get the ball back for its offense.
Deion Holloman, 399 combined kick return yards coming into today. Good for top 15 in the FCS. They're on 29. There's movement, and now more Leathernecks come across.
I believe that there's encroachment there on 50 for Western Illinois.
False start. Offense, number 66. 5-yard penalty. Still first down.
We'll get Sam Elefritz.
Well, Pete Swenson kind of jumped first, and then Elefritz kind of moved after that.
But you're not in stripes. Let's see.
He jumped right there, and then he comes up that way.
Yeah.
Now, the deal is if you can get back before the ball snapped.
Bears overload the right side here. And we'll run that way. Crowder. Boy, just not much there. Out of bounds around the 25. 29 seconds to go in the first quarter. Keep it on the 24 for second and 15. We'll have to run a play here. Play clock at 12. And Lambert's pass caught at the 30. And the reach by Holloman, but that's good for just a yard best.
Well, the problem is that those routes are just, they were running those routes and turning right at the line of scrimmage before the penalty. And that's not going to get you much.
And timeout called by Western Illinois with 1 second left in the quarter. So they use their second timeout to get one more play with the wind at their back here.
Didn't work last time. Charlie Fisher burning some timeouts in his first half. Up 10-0.
Charlie Fisher, a former head coach of West Georgia in the 90s, 1993 to 97. An assistant at North Carolina State, at Temple, Vanderbilt, you said earlier, Miami of Ohio, Penn State, and he came to Western Illinois from Richmond, where he was an assistant for 2 years and had an FCS playoff appearance.
Coached on the offensive side of the ball, and when he was over at Vanderbilt, Coach Jay Cutler, who's the Chicago Bears quarterback.
The final play of the first quarter, and Lambert with some time. And on the far sideline, it's caught at the 39. And that's good for a first down to Deion Holloman.
Nice catch, and then he lifts his hand, tries to get the crowd into it.
Bears will have it at their own 40 after the break. 10-0 Western Illinois after one quarter here at Plaster Stadium in Springfield on KOZL. Has a 10-0 lead after a quarter.
Complete control for Western Illinois in that first quarter, 10-0 lead, but Missouri State with a big first down catch by Deion Holloman right at the end of the first quarter. We'll see if that can get the momentum. They got the ball on their 40 and marching now with the wind as they head toward the end zone.
8 first downs to 2 for Western Illinois in the first 15 minutes. Flinching and now some adjustments on both sides. And Lambert with a give. Crowder, nowhere to go.
4 Leathernecks right there. Snuffed that play out.
Mick Nelson gets the finish. Nelson, 6'3 and 281. Junior right tackle. And it's a loss of three. Lambert down the middle, and that would have been six, but
wide open.
Past.
Wide open.
Nick Masoner out of the backfield.
One of Steck's favorite players just likes the motor that Masoner has out there, and boy, he came out of the fullback position and then just straight up the seam, untouched, nobody there. The ball just off his fingertips.
So third and 13. Lambert with some time, and now it runs out, and it's intercepted at the 46-yard line, and coming the other way for Western Illinois is Quentin Moon, the linebacker.
He was hit. Lambert was. He had a little bit of time, and then right when he's about to throw the ball, he got hit, and that caused that to be floated up in the air for Moon to get. Here's another look at that.
Boy, nice spin and tackle there. Pursuit by Adam Brott. Western Illinois ball at the Bears 46. Broke away from Coleman Clanton, the offensive lineman for the Bears.
He was throwing toward Holloman in triple coverage there as well, so maybe not the best place to be throwing to aiming at anyway at the beginning.
Hand off to Steve McShane.
And that's what the Leathernecks can do. I mean, they get you with running and passing. And McShane was really, you know, the bread and butter for the Leathernecks on their first drive, their scoring drive, their touchdown. Now, again, going into the wind, try to eat up a little bit of clock, keep it on the ground, and picked up, gashed up there for 8 yards.
Five carries for 20 yards for McShane there in the first quarter. Leathernecks with second and three. And passing as he was hit there. McGuire completes it to McShane at the 30. And that's a first down.
McNeese Egbin on the rush there and had his hands around McGuire's waist as he was throwing the ball. So just a second too late for that completion there.
Egbin has become the Bears' second leading tackler behind Dylan Cole.
And he can get to the quarterback. He's a couple of sacks already in his season here for the Bears.
Another next at the Bears 29 with a first and 10.
He's another one of these young Bear Cubs, a redshirt freshman. Penalty flag coming in the backside of this one.
McShane on the carry.
Two of them down. Two flags.
And they'll place him for likely the same infraction here.
Holding. Offense. Number 73. 10-yard penalty. Still first down.
That is Matt Zobrist, the right guard.
And that evens up, I think, the penalties on both sides.
Let's check in with Megan Rice.
Thanks, guys. Lance Lenore, who we've seen do some damage already in this game, comes out of Crete Moni High School in Illinois, where he was on the same team as the top-rated receiver in the country, Laquan Treadwell, who is currently on the Minnesota Vikings. While being paired with Treadwell probably took away some school's interest, Lenore couldn't be happier to be at Western Illinois. Well, he will go down as one of the best Leatherneck receivers in school history. And one more quick note on Lenore, the senior is getting a law enforcement degree and wants to be a federal crime scene investigator. That is, of course, if he doesn't, go to the NFL. Guys, back to you.
All right, thanks, Megan. The screen pass there incomplete.
Big pass rush by Tristan Crowder there. Freshman out of Bartlesville, Oklahoma, coming off the edge from Missouri State. And that put the pressure on McGuire.
So after that penalty, now second and 20. Back at the Bears 39 in Western Illinois. Moving into the strong wind in the second quarter. Leathernecks a 10-0 lead. McGuire's pass complete to McShane. Back close to the 30. Tackled by McNeese Egbin.
again, pressure there for the Bears, really stepping up. And Eggman, redshirt freshman. You've got a true freshman that was pressuring earlier, that Crowder, Tristan.
Pickup of 7, so 3rd and 13. At the Bears 32.
You know, you're going to look for Lenore, but don't forget Borsellino, that's up on the top side of your of the play here, the line of scrimmage. He's cutting across.
Wire deep and caught at the 15 for a 1st and 10.
Back shoulder pass to number 2.
That's Isaiah LeSueur. And LeSueur with his 11th catch of the year. He goes over 100 receiving yards with 2 touchdown catches.
Nice defense by the Bears, but look at the back, you know, the back shoulder for LeSueur there for the catch. So many weapons.
The Bears 15. The fake, and look out. The sack.
And who is it? Kern Blamey.
From Monett, Missouri. Kern Blamey.
He played safety at Monett. Put 25 pounds on to play linebacker for Missouri State. And he says they said they had no problems moving him because he likes to hit, as you can see right there.
That's a 9-yard loss. Back to the 24.
Steck talking about Blamey. He goes, Blamey likes to play right on the line. Right on the line. He says he likes that about the player, but once he steps over the line, he's going to choke him.
Passing play, and the Bears to McGuire again.
And that was Kobe Isbell. Back-to-back sacks for the Bears. Colburn in there as well with Isbell. As you can see, coming off of the right side. 3 of them in there.
Leathernecks working in reverse here, back to the 31-yard line. They have to get to the 5 for a first down on this third down play. Remember, if they go back much further, they'll be out of field goal range into the wind. Draw. And McGuire back inside the 25 to the 23, but that's it. Field goal from here would be about 40 yards.
Yeah, it gets him back into field goal range. Strong leg by their kicker.
Well, it better be into a 20-mile-an-hour
right.
Wind. So they'll try this with Nathan Knuffman.
Knuffman's got a strong leg, left-footed kicker.
4 of 6 on field goals with a long of 43.
Before the game, he was taking all of his practices into the wind at that same spot, and the Bears are going to ice him here with a timeout.
Missouri State, that's their first yard timeout of the half. Well, the first called timeout for Dave Steckel and the Bears. 9:14 to go, second quarter here in Springfield.
Knuffman coming out here. One of the top place kickers in the country, up for the Fred Mitchell Award watch list. His career long is 43, so he's at about that right now going into that strong wind.
Now that makes you wonder what Western Illinois has in mind here.
Well, and that's why Steck calls a timeout, to have Charlie maybe think about it again on the other side. Do you go ahead and let him try, or do you try something else?
Coming crowd today at Plaster. Missouri State's basketball team's practice today at JQH Arena. It was open to the public. Men's soccer tonight at 7 against Drake. All a part of homecoming. From 40 yards, the left footer got the distance. And it's no good. Wide to the right.
Not sure if somebody got a hand on that. It kind of looked like it changed trajectory as it went over the line of scrimmage, but it did go hook to the right a little bit. So good defensive stand for Missouri State, getting the ball back now and keeping Western Illinois off the scoreboard.
9:09 to go, second quarter in Springfield. Still 10-0 Western Illinois. It's Bears football on KOZO. Lead on Indiana State 17-10 in the first quarter.
Nice crowd on hand for this homecoming game.
South Dakota State and North Dakota State in the Dakota Marker game. No score in the middle of the first quarter. Later on this evening, it's Northern Iowa and Youngstown State and Southern Illinois versus Illinois State. The Bears at their own 23 to start.
Nice hole pounded open by the right side of the Bears line there for Jason Randall as he goes and picks up about 6 yards.
To the 28.
And remember, now Jason Randall can go out of the Wildcat, and it looks like that's what's going to happen here. Maybe. Watch for the direct snap.
Indeed it is. And he'll keep it. Crosses the 30 to the 31. You saw that coming.
Interesting that Lambert kind of goes to the left side, but he still claps his hands to get the cadence ready to go, even though it's going to be snapped right around. Now Randall's looking at some of the offensive coaches. Yeah, let's keep doing this. Let's keep doing it.
Everybody wants to be quarterback.
I talked to Steck about that. I said, you know, who came up with that idea? And he's not giving the credit to anybody. He says it was a bunch of different guys in the offensive room that came up with that. There's the direct snap.
With Lambert just kind of watching. And here goes Randall to the 30-20. 10 to the 5 and out of bounds.
Who chased him down? My goodness. And he may be hurt. That's number 5 for them, number 9. Check out, if you can see this play, Lambert is the quarterback. He's looking to the side, and the direct snap goes to Randall. Nice inside block there up the middle. And then he's chased down by the Leathernecks, number 5, knocks him out of bounds.
Aaron Diggs.
Right, and he was questionable going into the game. Now the pass to a wide-open Furmanek for a touchdown. Bears on the board.
Eric Furmanek connects with Lambert.
That's why you put the Wildcat in the playbook. A little deception there. Brody Lambert again, looking to the side like they do. You know, you see him sometimes pull up in the middle of the cadence and look over to the side if the play changes, and then when that happened, the direct snap went to Jason Randall, and then he just took off down the sideline.
Zach Drake on the PAT. 18 of... Check that. The kick is good. And the kick makes it 10-7. Western Illinois, the Bears on the scoreboard. Nick from 6 yards, connecting with Lambert. It was set up by the 63-yard run by Jason Randall, and Missouri State is down by just 3.
We talked about that Wildcat with Jason Randall, and the first time we saw that, it was against Indiana State, and you can see Coach Coughlin down there, the offensive line coach for Missouri State. He kind of came up with the idea of using Jason Randall as that Wildcat against the Sycamores. He saw another team using it against the Sycamores, and Randall had a little bit of the skills there. I talked to Jason about it, and he said that it helps because he gets the ball quicker with the reads, and he can decide what he wants to do more quickly when he gets the ball in his hands. Now, talking with Steck says he doesn't even want him thinking about throwing the ball. He just wants him to tuck the ball and run, and that was a key there. 63-yard play. That got the spark going for this Missouri State offense, and see if the Bears can get this game tied back up or take the lead before halftime.
Zach Drake is going to need a holder now, maybe. Doesn't want one, but bring in Trey Betts to hold for him. Western Illinois, the first 10 points of the game, all in the first quarter. Bears answer here in the middle of the second. And this one will sail out the back of the end zone and out to the 25.
Just like Otto for the Leathernecks.
Going that direction.
All right, now the Missouri State Bears defense really coming up strong the last couple of drives for Western Illinois. So we'll see if they can keep hot and see if they can get the ball back to the Bears offense. Or get a turnover. They've got 13 turnovers so far in this season. And still waiting to see if they can get one tonight.
On the receiving end of them,
yeah,
right?
Yeah. Interceptions and fumble recoveries. Dylan Cole has a couple of interceptions, and he's forced three fumbles. And you've seen a really good pass rush from the Bears, especially the right side of their defensive line, with Isbell getting in there for a couple of sacks and Blaney on a blitz.
Almost incomplete to Joey Borsellino. Out close to the 35, that would be a first down if he's there.
Anthony Upchurch for the Bears on the defense there, and looks like he had one hand on that ball as the Leatherneck was making the reception, trying to poke it out. He comes out of the game right now.
Gain of 9.5.
Kind of worried a little bit more about getting the ball and making the tackle, and he was able to get some yards after the catch.
High formation on second down. Straight handoff goes to Jamie Gilmore, and he'll have the first down at the 39. Jared Bishore on the stop for Missouri State from Lamar, Missouri.
Bears took their heavy option off, getting their kind of their nickelback defense back in there.
Lamar was a big winner in high school football last night on perhaps starting a new road to maybe their sixth straight state championship.
They are 8-0, perfect on the season. Glendale 9-0, perfect on the season, and caught up with Coach Mike Mock here on the field visiting before this game, and he mentioned to us that he wanted to take a look at Plaster Stadium because he's hoping maybe his team would get here toward the end near Thanksgiving,
yeah,
for where they're going to have some state championship games.
Thanksgiving weekend, the classes 1-5 state championship games will be right here.
Riley Shantz, the center for Missouri State, is a Glendale Falcon as well.
Second and 3. Give to Gilmore, or second and 7. A gain of 3 on that last play. This will add about 6 to it out to the 48-yard line. Mike Mock, surviving colorectal cancer and doing very well with his Glendale Falcon team at 9-0. He had his defensive star Kyle Doran with him today, who leads the galaxy in tackles in high school football.
Yeah, if you want to play defense at the FCS level, why don't you come to Missouri State, one of the best defensive teams in the country when it comes to that. And you got to learn behind, you got guys like Schafitzel, you got guys like Dylan Cole.
Third down, and into Bears territory is Gilmore for the Leatherneck first down, tackled by Darius Joseph.
Three straight plays for Western Illinois, three straight handoffs to Gilmore, and he gets another first down. Making it look easy here. Gilmore, number 5, a little bit more speedy than McShane.
And there's a Bear doubled over here.
Skyler Holse.
So they'll take a look at him.
Didn't see what happened with him.
5:21 to go before halftime. Pride Band starts to take its place down on the sideline.
Healthy contingent of Leatherneck fans up in the shade at Plaster Stadium here. And you kind of want to find some shade. It's like 80-something degrees out there.
Well, Hulse off under his own power. Missouri State at Northern Iowa next week. 1 o'clock start in the Uni Dome. Western Illinois will host North Dakota State.
Bison very, very tough. You know, the Bears have kind of gone through the gauntlet of their schedule, going to, you know, the Big 12's K-State Wildcats, Indiana State, followed by the number one team in the country. So some tough games out of the way. Now it's time to try to get some wins and claw your way up into the upper division of the Valley. They're at 1-1 right now. And a little opportunity. You got Northern Iowa that's maybe down a little bit, going up to their place, and then back home again.
Coach Steck takes it all in on the sidelines. That hashtag bear up that he came up with as soon as he got to Springfield.
He's a Seinfeld fan, a freak fan of Seinfeld, and loves the Kramer's giddy up. It was all giddy up is what Kramer always said, and he turned that into bear up. And really got the students behind it, and then the Springfield fans behind it, and now it's just a Missouri State phenomenon. Everybody knows what bear up means here.
Ball at the Bears 44, first and 10, Western Illinois. First coverage today sponsored by Andy Bees.
The last time that the 11X were in this position, the Bears defense really came up with a couple of sacks and stopped the drive, and they missed that field goal.
The roll out, McGuire, and it's dropped by Gilmore.
Boy, it looked like Gilmore had that in his hands for a couple of steps, didn't it?
Almost. Gilmore from Ocala, Florida, a senior.
First time, really, that we've seen the Leathernecks kind of roll one way or the other out of the pocket, a designed roll, you know, as opposed, because he's had, you know, some time, so maybe that Bears defense really pressuring the offensive line for Western Illinois.
Bears 44 again, back to Gilmore, and just a yard or so at best. Bears really bear up on defense this time.
Didn't get anything there. Isbell coming up a little bit, looks like his right shoulder maybe a little bit, kind of got a little pop there, slow getting up from the turf, but he stays in the game.
Under 5 minutes to go in the half. Among our halftime festivities today, a visit with Randy Ball, who coached both of these teams.
Randy Ball coached Western Illinois in the mid-90s, and then, of course, in the early 2000s here at Missouri State, was inducted into the Missouri Sports Hall of Fame, and we'll hear from Coach at halftime, so stick around for that. Working for the Chiefs now.
Across the middle. Ooh, incomplete.
There was Cameron Price again. Redshirt freshman almost picked that off. The ball was in his hands.
So it is fourth down. Leathernecks will punt for field position here now.
You know, we talk a little bit about, you know, Blamey's a junior. You've got Dylan Cole, who's a senior. But there's a lot of freshmen and redshirt freshmen on that Bears defense, and they're really stout. So a lot of promise for that for the Missouri State future.
Deion Holloman back for Missouri State.
Holloman will let it go. And this is going to into the end zone. Two Leathernecks crash into each other.
See, that's in baseball. Those where you have to call it.
Yeah.
You know, I'm going to take care of it. So you've got a looks like a linebacker and a D-back that both went after that ball.
Well, it was well placed here, but doink.
Man. I think, you know, you think number six, Xavier Rowe, he got the worst end of that crashing into that guy.
Hunter Varga was the other.
Oh, a little bit of weight difference there between those two. And
Varga, the long snapper.
How about that? The long snapper is the one that gets all the way down there.
That's what he was listed as, anyway.
Yeah. Nice hustle by those guys.
So out to the 20.
He beats the one.
Yeah. Lambert steps back, fires deep, then incomplete.
I just look. I see something blowing down. It's a leaf. I was looking for a little bit of laundry because that D-back on him was all over him on that route.
Zach Hoover coming off.
Yeah, Zach Hoover was the one running the route, and looks like
Xavier Rowe again.
Yeah, Rowe. But I mean, they were stride for stride, and it was tough there. No flag though.
But a leaf on the play.
Right, leaf on the play. That gets you nothing.
Okay.
That gets you second and 10.
4:08 before halftime. Bears down a field goal.
That's what I'm talking about.
Room here on a run for Brody Lambert out to the 26.
Dropped back and then just tucked it and went right up the middle of the field. There's a, you know, nobody covering him. That gives you an opportunity. Move that chains a little bit. Sets you up for a nice third down option here.
Yeah, give him a 7-yard gain to the 27.
Now you've got Kalen Crowder that's standing next to him this time instead of Jason Randall. That's about where they went the last time for that Wildcat play.
Steck wants timeout.
He must not have liked what he saw defensively for the play that he had called, because that one, he called that one right before the snap.
So the second timeout for Missouri State. Each team has one left with 3:37 to go before the half. Well, Missouri State has given up 10 points, but they've gotten a lot of good done on defense as well today.
One of the strongest defenses in the Valley and in the FCS. Let's take a look at some of the plays here. Nice tackle there. Dylan Cole.
And Cole again.
Blaney off the edge.
And the big rush. Isbell
leading the way. Pack of Bears there. There they are, Dylan Cole. That's the defensive coordinator, Coach Yokley there.
Darius Joseph listening in as well.
Blamey.
Dylan Cole, a star running back for Logan Rogersville High School, state champion in 2011. Can see the end of the line here now for his Bears career. Rogersville beat John Burroughs in the championship game in 2011. Ezekiel Elliott a part of that Burroughs team, and now good a running back as there is in the NFL for the Dallas Cowboys. Lambert rolls. He'll look. Cannot get away from the first wave there. Pete Swenson.
Kind of had tried to get one man to beat and couldn't get it done. Interesting play call after that timeout from Missouri State.
Ezekiel Elliott also came to Monette and played a state semifinal game when he was a senior before he went to Ohio State.
Now he's got Cowboy Nation all excited.
Oh, yeah.
High snap there for Zach, but he was able to call it down and get a nice punt with the wind.
To the 20-yard line for Lenore. Look out. Lenore 30. Down at the 37.
Firmanek, who caught the Missouri State touchdown, was there to make the tackle. And that was a key play by Zach Drake, because if that ball would have snapped over his head into the end zone, that could have been disastrous for Missouri State. But as it is, Drake was able to get it down and get a nice punt back, and 2:48 left in this first half. Bears really want to try to see what they can do to continue to bottle up this Leatherneck offense. After that first quarter, they've been doing a really good job of stalling out what the Leathernecks want to do. That pass rush has kind of taken away the passing game for them in this second quarter. There's Zach right now. He's talking about it. You see the way I jumped up there and saved the touchdown? Yeah. And then there's Brandon, the other punter, standing next to him. Yeah. I taught you everything you knew.
Withrow there?
Yeah, Withrow there with the crutches. Yeah, he tore his knee ligaments in the game against Murray State on a fake punt. Steck calling a fake punt and didn't even get the first down before he tore his knee ligaments.
He punted six times before the injury.
Interesting play there. Dylan Cole had filled the slot that McShane wanted to run into, and he was able to just step a little bit to the right and then pick up the yards.
Steve McShane to the 45 for a gain of eight.
And that's what Steck's saying about him. You know, he says not the fastest running back that there is, but boy, he's elusive, and he can just see the field and know where to, you know, where to move to get the extra yard or two.
Short yardage play here for Western Illinois.
That time it didn't work.
Oh boy, right to McShane. And that'll lose a couple.
Upchurch again, nice play by him.
Yeah, Anthony Upchurch, a safety.
And he's only a sophomore.
Out of Memphis. So a 3-yard loss. It's 3rd and 5 for Western Illinois. And we're under 2 minutes to go before the half. Step back, McGuire, pass complete at the 49. First down, Western Illinois, Joey Borsellino.
Borsellino just knew exactly where to cut that route off, right at the first down marker. Hauled it in. Like I said, he's had 2,000 yards in his career, along with Lenore, who has 3,000 yards. Pet peeve, you know, if you're a fan, you got the receivers not going and running their routes there. I mean, he threw it right into double coverage, but Borsellino able to hold on and get the first down. Now, play action pass.
And complete at midfield. That's McShane.
Again, Upchurch with a nice tackle there to keep that one from getting any more. Little hurry-up offense for Western Illinois. We're down to 59 seconds left in the second quarter.
Each team with one timeout remaining in the half. Quick hitter to Lenore. And out of bounds.
Smart
42.
Play. Uh-huh. Smart play. Only picked up a couple of yards, but you swing the ball out to your hot receiver, and you stop the clock, and you get another a chance to change some personnel and get another play in.
So it's 3rd and 1.
Now, they're taking both Borsellino and Lenore out, so obviously you're going to go with your heavy package here, your fullback and your McShane back there behind them.
And here it goes. McShane to the 30 as he picks up 12 on 3rd and 1. McNeese Egbom on the tackle.
34 yards so far in this game for number 34. Check out the hole that he has. The offensive line opening up. You can get a, you know, Winnebago through that line right there. And that was on a third and short. And they were able to poke that hole out and get him down there. Injury for Missouri State at this point. Somebody holding his knee.
And so it is
Darius Daniel.
Okay.
Junior out of Mark Tree, Arkansas. Now it's hot, so you know you think maybe there's some cramping going on or something like that could be a little bit of a problem too, with some of these players that have gone down a couple of times, both on both sides, 80 something degrees with the wind and the sun out there today.
Cool week of practice.
Yeah, that's the thing, that the heat just came today.
Keep an eye on 24. Here he comes.
Yeah. You can see when
the knees were just everywhere.
Well, the helmet came in and hit his right knee on that play. He came over the top to clean up that play. And he's going out with looks like maybe his left knee or right knee, one of those.
Hard to tell by that walk.
Right.
Darius Daniel out.
Another one of these young defensive Bears.
Ball at the 30-yard line.
34,
the Leathernecks.
34 seconds left in this quarter. Lenore back in. He's on the near side along with Borsellino.
It is a 1st and 10. Take the McShane. McGuire looks, and that's a pass. Incomplete.
And that was Tony Jones with the pressure on McGuire, and I mean almost reached up and was able to knock that ball down on that rush. He tried to almost shot put it to his to McShane, who was back and blocking.
Homecoming court in the stands.
They're going to name a king and a queen here at halftime.
Three seconds before the half. Down to Lenore at the 10. Shakes his man and is inside the 5 for a first and goal.
Boy, how can you leave him like that? I mean, there must have been some kind of a mix-up on the secondary coverage there, because it looks like Missouri State's cornerback just kind of let him go, thinking that there was going to be cover over the top.
And a spike.
Darius Joseph was out there, and he had Lenore on the first part of that play and then kind of let him go, thinking that maybe somebody was behind him. And Lenore just kind of camped out on the far sideline in the open space. Let's take another look at that. And it was Cameron Price coming in. And you almost think that remember Darius Joseph got hurt on the play before that. Or not Darius Joseph, but the guy that kind of came off with that knee injury.
Darius Daniel,
so.
The 13 seconds, second and goal after the spike. McGuire, pass, caught, I think. Let's see, yes, touchdown, Western Illinois.
The official was right there. It wasn't so much a question of whether his feet were in the end zone. It was more was whether or not he held on to the ball, and he was able to do that.
Isaiah LeSure.
Another big catch for him. You know, we talked about the other two guys for them, but it's LeSure that comes up with the touchdown here. Good coverage from Missouri State. And they are looking at it because they review all touchdowns here. Can't really see from that because he went out of frame right when the question was whether or not he was juggling the ball or not, and whether he had his feet down in the end zone. So we'll see what happens. Only have to have one.
So on this day of video, they review all touchdowns and turnovers when the technology is there. Oh, boy.
That 1 foot's awful close. I mean, you saw. Yeah, let's take a wider look at this.
Needing the 1 foot.
I'm not so sure if he got 1 foot. He may have got one knee down. But then the other thing was the official was standing there looking at whether or not he had control of the ball as he was going down as well. Everybody kind of waiting on. You know, the Missouri Valley does have a TV replay, and they look at all scoring plays, turnovers, that situation. They're talking now with him.
Referee Matt Gallagher. Replay booth right up here to our left, and keeping a close eye on everything. Here we are.
After further review, the ruling of a touchdown stands. Try for point.
So McGuire with the touchdown pass to LeSure. And it was Jared Bishore with defense on there. And, you know, you really couldn't have much better defense on that. He had him well covered. But he was able to get it in there for the touchdown.
Extra point try. Nathan Knuffman. And he puts it through. 6 seconds left in the half. The Leathernecks add 7, and it's 17-7, Western Illinois.
You got a nice drive from Western Illinois. I mean, they were able to take the ball, use their two-minute offense, mix both the run and the pass, and then you take it down in there close. Remember that nice catch by Lenore on the far sideline that he kind of got in the seam of the zone defense to get him down on the doorstep, and then the nice pass in there. So Western Illinois with the touchdown answered Missouri State's touchdown, but still a game, 17-7 against the 12th ranked team in the country, getting close to halftime.
Again at the half, among our presentations at halftime, a visit that Dan had with Randy Ball, who coached both at Western Illinois and here at Missouri State.
Took the Leathernecks to a couple of playoff trips through the FCS at the end of his tenure there, then came to Missouri State and coached from 99 to 2005 and was inducted into the Missouri Sports Hall of Fame on Monday, part of their football luncheon. And he now is an advanced scout with the Kansas City Chiefs. And it's interesting. I said, well, who are you scouting? And he said that he scouts the other NFL teams for people that they may cut loose or become free agents or who somebody they could trade with to improve their team throughout the season. Plus, he is scouting the team that they will play next. So, looking at the New Orleans Saints this weekend. Onside kick kind of scrubs it to the short.
Squib kick, anyway.
Yep.
Brought back by Chris Cacciarelli back across the 40, and that'll run out the first half clock. So, halftime, homecoming at Missouri State. It is 17-7, Western Illinois with a lead over the Missouri State Bears. Back in a minute.
Gary, Gary, I am proud of you, my man. Making simple, smart cashback choices.
Thing was blown up from the beginning. Yet Mikey Bart in the back.
And we'll be ready for second half action at Plaster when we come back on KOZL. It's
Bears. The things the Bears could clean up here in the second half. He says the offense isn't sustaining any drives. The defense is on the field way too long, and they need to get a stop on third down. I also asked him about Malik Earl's injury. He said that's no reason why this team is down 17-7 right now. Other guys need to step up. Guys, back to you.
And Bear up.
Nice play there for the Bears, and Missouri State may have gotten away with something because it looked like Darrell Colburn jumped just a hair, but he timed it just perfectly to get in there and disrupt that play.
They move it forward maybe a foot or so. Ball at the 33-yard line for 3rd and 7 for Western Illinois. Sean McGuire, 15 of 23 through the air in the first half for 156.
And it was interesting, we talked a lot about Lance Lenoir, but he only had, you know, 4 catches for 53 yards in that.
Still not bad.
No.
100-yard pace, anyway.
Right.
But he's had 2 200-yard receiving games.
Isbell almost got his 3rd knockdown, and then a late flag coming in on that play. LeSure on the far side for Illinois State, and this doesn't look like it's going to be good for Missouri State. It's almost as like the official couldn't find the flag to throw earlier. And that's Darius Joseph, the cornerback back there that was covering LeSure.
Pass interference. Defense number 30.
Oh.
Ball he placed at the spot of the foul. Automatic first down.
They got Jared Beshore for that. And I'm not sure that... Okay, yeah, I was going to say, I'm not sure he was even on the field. There he is. On how he can be on the right side of the field, and then the penalty came on the left side of the field. We'll just see from there.
Well, they mark it at the Leathernecks' own 48-yard line and a 1st and 10.
It was number 2 that was covering LeSure on that side, so I don't know whether or not what the situation was there.
McGuire's pass incomplete. Lenoir was in the neighborhood.
And that was their blitz coming in. On the far side, Anthony Upchurch again off the edge on the blitz. And he was draped all over McGuire when he threw that ball. Watch him come in, straight blitz, untouched. Got there right when he let go of the ball with his left forearm into the kidneys.
Second and 10 for Missouri State. McShane ran the ball 9 times for a net of 46 in the first half.
Gets it again here.
And he'll get it. Oh, and just gets rammed from behind at the hands of Tony Jones.
Good to see him coming in there and sniffing out a play. He was banged up a little bit in that second quarter.
3rd and 10.
Well, this will be a big play for this Missouri State defense. Just chased him down from the backside.
I always wonder how players can hang on to the football when they get hit like that from behind and don't see it coming.
Yeah, you don't see it coming. And usually you see the guy hitting you coming from the front side.
McGuire. Out and incomplete.
Nice defense. Nice defensive hold. That snap was a little funky. It looked like it came out kind of knuckleball a little bit, and McGuire had to reach down to get it and maybe threw his timing off. The receiver was open, but the pass wasn't there.
Borsellino, the target there, one. Three catches for 22 yards in the first half for him.
All right, Deion Holloman back there. See if he can return this punt. See if he can get something going on special teams to get Missouri State back in this.
Wind at the back of the punter, Nathan Knuffman. Angle to the right down the middle. Hits at the goal line and then bounces out in to come out to the 20. And Western would probably rather have that than kick it to Holloman even at the one.
Yeah, that was a night. And has, what, 16 or 17 now touchbacks so far in this season. And then you got Knuffman. And then you got Knuffman with the punting and the place kicking. Brody Lambert back out there.
Missouri State from the 20. Kalen Crowder there, 28, to run behind him. LaMarcus Stewart and Zach Hoover come out and split to the left.
Those guys started on the right side and then after a delay swung around trying to maybe mess up the Western Illinois defense a little.
Give to Crowder. And falls ahead for gain of about six.
Just extra effort there, just kept his feet moving, and it looked like the left-neck defender had him by the pants, and he was just able to pull away a little bit to get another 6 yards.
Had a six-yard run in the first half, but netted just five on four carries in the entire half. Crowder again to the 29. It will be third and one for the Bears.
Key for Steck, I mean, he wants to be able to take this offensive drive and not only, you know, obviously move the ball down the field and try to get some points, but get that defense another couple of extra minutes to rest and recoup and stay fresh. They did just come out of locker room, a long halftime, but still.
Crashes into the wall at the 30-yard line there, but falls ahead to the 31.
I think his third effort was what got him the first down there. It looked like he was initially stopped, but then the defenders kind of pushed him forward, and he got the first down.
And good work here by Kalen Crowder, and he comes out.
It seems like he stopped right there, but then he just keeps moving his feet and pushes the pile forward to get the first down.
Phoenix Johnson in at a running back. Play fake to him. Lambert's pass is caught by LaMarcus Stewart and out of bounds across the 40.
Tough throw for Brody Lambert. Nice first down for Missouri State. Rolls to his left this time and was able to make the reception. Nice pass on the run.
42-yard line, first and 10. Still a lot of time on the play clock, and the Bears do this.
They kind of pull up and look over to the sideline, and there's three assistant coaches going through hand signals.
Marcus Stewart at midfield, and then driven back from there.
He caught that in the breadbasket, then it looked like he kind of lost control of the ball for just a second, and then reached down and got it. So Bears moving the ball here, first possession of the second half.
Three catches for 27 yards on the season coming into this game for LaMarcus Stewart. Gain of eight, second and two.
Phoenix Johnson, first action for the Web City product here in this third quarter.
Flip it out, it's caught by Furmanek. He has a first down, well into Western Illinois territory.
Furmanek's had a really big game for Missouri State, tight end. Coming out, he got the touchdown catch in the second quarter, and then there, big first down. Bears moving the chains, moving the ball down the field.
Leatherneck 32, Western Illinois up 17-7. Bears got a stop to start the second half, and then the ball, and now chance to get within a field goal. If they can get it in the end zone. Lambert going that way, and caught for the touchdown, Deion Holloman.
We talked before the game. Will the alarm clock go off for Deion Holliman? He's been kind of quiet. He opened up the season with a 90-something touchdown, kickoff return for a touchdown. And here, another touchdown from Missouri State. Nice pass from Brody Lambert. Right down over three defenders into the hands of Holliman, and he gets the touchdown. All kinds of time over the defenders, and then Holliman is right there for the touchdown.
Extra point try now for Zach Drake. The pass from 32 yards to Deion Holliman. And PAT up and good. And Missouri State alive and well for homecoming here in Springfield. 17-14, Western Illinois by just three.
It's had this season against Indiana State, coming from behind to, losing the lead in the second half and then coming from behind. So this team will not give up. You know, don't expect them to fold their tents at all. Straight quarterback keeper here.
And look at McGuire go into Missouri State territory. Gets close to 9 yards.
Had all of his buddies on the offensive line pushing him forward.
McGuire, sophomore quarterback, a team captain, was named a National Offensive Player of the Week last year. Coach Charlie Fisher, the sidelines for the Leathernecks.
Second stint as a head coach at West Georgia before that, and then a long number of years as an assistant coach.
Lenore inside the 10-yard line. Dylan Cole tried to knock the ball out of there, but they call it down, and Western Illinois that quickly will have a first and goal.
How Lenore can get so wide open. I mean, he was just wide open in the middle of the field for that ball. Little slant pattern. He kind of juggles it when he makes the catch here, coming across. And then let's see the end of this play. Yeah, the ground causing the fumble there. Official right there on the play.
First and goal at the 9. Gilmore spins down to the 6.
Gilmore kind of started everything off with that big kickoff return after Missouri State's touchdown.
Well, Lance Lenore and South Dakota State's Jake Weineke are chasing the Missouri Valley Football Conference career leader in receiving yards. That is Diedrich Ward, who played at Northern Iowa from 1993 to 96, 3,876 yards. Played in the NFL, and then for 1 year coached here at Missouri State, the first year Terry Allen was here. Ball down to the 1 yard line for Gilmore.
Yeah, T.A., of course, assistant coach up at Northern Iowa, played at Northern Iowa, quarterback coach there, a guy named Kurt Warner.
Yeah.
And brought Diedrich down here as an assistant coach in his first year.
To the 1, third and goal. And there's a bear down.
McNeese Egbem, maybe.
They'll take a look at him. Missouri State with home games coming against Southern Illinois in 2 weeks at 2 o'clock. Youngstown State, November 19th. We'll take a break, 17-14. Western Illinois the lead, looking for more.
All right, here's the thing with mobile banking.
Joe Turk, 41. Third and goal at the 1. It's Jamie Gilmore. And close. Touchdown. Touchdown signal from the linesman on this side. Yes.
Colin Best there made the first hit, and he was trying to keep him from crossing the plane. Not able to do that. So Western Illinois answers Missouri State's touchdown. Here again, the scrum in the middle, and then he pushes it over. Yeah, no problems there.
Kick for Nathan Knuffman. hit a 33-yard field goal earlier in the first quarter. Good on his extra points so far. And this one is into Bearfest Village. And good.
Didn't take Western Illinois long. Lenore with that nice catch and that drive.
7-11 to go in the third quarter here in Springfield. Western Illinois back out to a 10-point advantage over Missouri State. Hey, Bears trail 24-14.
I was going to say, great to have this homecoming game on KOZL and have people around the Ozarks in southwest Missouri be able to see the Missouri State Bears and see what Valley football is about. I mean, we're talking about FCS, this division. It's a nice, you know, competitive division in this Missouri Valley Conference, the best conference in FCS football. Six teams out of this conference beat teams from the upper division in the preseason, and now they're beating up on each other here in conference play.
How about North Dakota State? They beat like six FBS opponents in a row now.
Five-time national champs, unbeaten, still ranked number one. Strong team. This Western Illinois team, strong. 12th in the country.
North Dakota State getting votes for the FBS top 25.
They've had five votes in the top 25 AP poll, which is funny. Yeah, which little respect there. Missouri State receiving some votes in the FCS polls as well. So we'll see what we can do here. Missouri State still 7 minutes and 11 seconds left in this third quarter. Really moved the ball well the first time they had it. And we were talking a little bit too. You know, they script their plays at the beginning of the game. They've been successful. And they did that in the third quarter. You know, curious as to whether or not that drive was scripted coming out of the locker room or they're just going with the regular game plan.
From the 25. It's Crowder at running back for the Bears. Lambert rolls to his right. Somebody got a finger on that one, and it's incomplete.
Yeah, Western Illinois' Colin Saunders there on the rush really forced him, and then 58 almost picked it off.
That's Riggs Baxter.
And that ball just off of his fingertips, but it was Colin who made the initial pressure there on Brody. Now trips to the top. Low snap.
Pass caught by Zach Hoover. And not much there at all.
Well, I mean, he had a blocker and he had some space. Problem was the low snap. I got Brody off of his little cadence a little bit there because he threw it behind Hoover. And he had to kind of reach back to make the reception. And then by that time, the Leathernecks defense was there.
2 yard gain, third and eight. Lambert in traffic. Incomplete, intended for Deion Holloman. It'll be fourth down.
Lambert kind of really looking toward Holloman. After that touchdown pass, had looked like five receivers in the pattern there, but going toward Holloman, and he had triple coverage when he was made the break out of his route.
Zach Drake, four punts in the first half for a 41-yard average.
The last thing Steck wanted to do is have his defense march back on the field again, but that's going to happen here in third quarter. There's that roll that you can get out of that rugby kick.
Down to 33-yard line. Mark it on the 33.
One of the things that Steck was talking about is that he noticed in the North Dakota State game is just the fatigue of the game. He says as his defense, and both defensively and offensive, you talk about the third and fourth quarters, the fatigue of the game goes on, and he needs his Bears to maintain their focus and their execution and stay sharp on their fundamentals. And, you know, when you have to keep going out there and try to stop this offense that has so many tools, it's a big challenge for the Bears defense.
Sean McGuire back to work. And under center on first and 10. Give to McShane. Can't get the corner turn. Down for a loss.
Defense was there. Darius Joseph came in there on the play.
Loss of one.
Yeah, and Alex Jones cleaned it up. As you can see, a little pressure there, a little pressure there, and then Jones comes over the top to clean that up. And Missouri State, they do. It's almost like hockey. They'll move two and three guys in every other play defensively, shifting the different guys that are back there. Jones playing instead of Dylan Cole. Cole getting a little bit of a break here.
Quick hitter. Could have been a lateral there, and it goes to Borsellino to the 40 and driven back from there. They'll give him progress to the 41.
Yeah, LeShore with a block there, but he was kind of grabbing and holding on Darius Joseph for the Bears, looking for something that didn't come there from the official. But he did turn the corner and pick up 8 yards.
So third and two.
Dylan Cole back in at the Mike linebacker from Missouri State.
5 minutes to go, third quarter. Third down, Leathernecks. And it's a give to McGuire. He stopped.
Yeah, I don't think he got it.
Or McGuire to McShane. For a gain of just one, needed two, so fourth and one.
Isbell there on the tackle from Missouri State. And they're going to punt.
Have to here with a 10-point yeah. lead in your own territory. Knuffman punted twice for a 43.5 average in the first half. To the near side of the field, Holloman will chase after it, but then get away, and it's going to roll down to the one.
Well, it looked like for a second that Holloman might be able to catch that in stride, but the Leathernecks cover team was down there, and then he kind of backed off, and then it got a really good roll all the way down to the one.
57 yards. The wind at his back for Knuffman.
Really just one punt return for Dion in this game, nothing from the kickoffs, and kind of frustrates you as a kick returner there as he comes off the sideline.
Bears with their backs against the wall. At their own one. Hand off at dangerous and just barely back to the one. And staying out of his own end zone, Crowder.
He got hit about a yard deep into the end zone and was able to fall forward. No gain on that play.
Lambert back, and it's caught by Hoover at the 10, and a knee goes down at the 11.
That's a first down, though, for Missouri State, and that's a big play. Nice catch by Hoover. He gets in that first down, gets him out of the shadow of the goalpost.
Just enough to move the chains. First down Bears to Hoover.
You can see right there, yeah. He also got touched when he was down too, but yeah, keep playing till you hear the whistle.
That's right. This one swung out. Out to the 14-yard line. The pass to Crowder. Gain of three.
Bears offense in this half looks like it's got a little bit more of a rhythm to it, you know what I'm saying? A lot better than it did in the first half for sure.
Phoenix Johnson comes in the backfield. It's second and seven for the Bears. Give to Johnson. Web City Cardinal. He is stopped for no gain.
Brett Taylor again, and he's been kind of quiet in this game. Only three tackles in the first half, and Dylan Cole had seven tackles for Missouri State. We kind of talked about that linebacker matchup at the beginning of the game, but a big tackle there for Brett Taylor brings up third down.
And back for a pass. The receiver falls down, and it's incomplete.
Don't look for a flag there because I think he just fell on his own. That was LaMarcus Stewart, and he was running on that far sideline and got his feet tripped up and just went down. I don't think he probably could have caught the pass anyway.
Well, the Bears move it 13 yards out to the 14, and we'll have to punt from there. And Stewart drops right there. Zach Drake will hit it just across the goal line.
Good.
And he barely gets it away.
And that one, yeah, I mean.
And it's partially blocked, says the referee, Matt Gallagher, so no penalty for roughing.
That was Javon Williams going in special teams for Western Illinois. You know, that rugby, you kind of run toward the right. You're supposed to be running behind your defensive protection, but Williams was able to get in there and get a hand on there.
He went all out for it. It's a 30-yard punt to the Bears' 44.
Yep. His hand got the ball right before it hit his foot. Boy, that sets him up here. Golden opportunity for Western Illinois to really put one of the nails into the coffin for the Bears here.
They could go up three scores here if they can get it in. And it's McGuire powering down to the 37.
He took a big hit from Missouri State's D-back there.
7-yard pickup, and that opens up the playbook for McGuire on second and three.
Looked like maybe Bishore was the one that made that hit on McGuire, but
fake to Gilmore, to the air, Lenore, to 15. And to the 10, he reaches for the pylon and is out of bounds along there inside the 5.
Well, Lenore is just able to get into the seams of the zone back there and again makes the catch. And Don, if I'm not mistaken, that puts him over 100 yards now.
Yep.
As he gets another 100-yard receiving game and gets him down close. Yeah, almost the pressure, the blitz from Missouri State. Anthony Upchurch coming in strong. But, oh, man. Did he get the ball on the pylon? There's a wingspan stretch there, right? They had the ball on the 4.
Yeah, well, the 3 anyway.
The three.
6 catches for 125 now for Lenore. Here's Gilmore, and he'll take it to the corner of the end zone for the touchdown for Western Illinois.
Untouched. Boy, I tell you, Lenore setting up the leatherback. The Leathernecks offense here. Every time that the Leathernecks have scored a touchdown, Lenore has had a big play leading up to it. So, boy, I tell you what, give the assist to number 7. Bounces to the outside, untouched.
And this extra point could put the Leathernecks up 3 scores. So the PAT by Knuffman up and good, and it's a 17-point lead for Western Illinois, 31-14 with 48 seconds to go in the third.
You got the little things there. The blocked punt was the one that got the ball, short field for them to kind of drive down. Here's another look at the play. Just kind of took it to the outside, bounced it in, 3 yards out. Another touchdown from Gilmore.
Missouri State Bears football sponsored on KOZL by Andy Bees. Bears have not been even or ahead in this game, I guess, except nothing. The Leathernecks have led all the way. First meeting in 3 years between these two football programs. You don't play everybody every year in the Missouri Valley Football Conference.
Yeah, 10 teams in the conference, and, they play everybody. You don't play everybody. So the Bears did not see Western Illinois for 2 seasons. They are not going to see South Dakota for 2 seasons. But for some reason, North Dakota State's just been on that schedule.
Went through a cycle with Youngstown State, too, with that. Out to the 25 again.
Well, it got to be frustrating for Steck and the defense, because you hold them, Western Illinois, and then they get the punt, and it gets that roll all the way down to the 1 yard line, and then they get the partial block of the punt coming out the other way, and then it turns into 7 points. So, little frustration for the Missouri State defense, and what they really need now is for the Bears to be able to mount a drive here, try to get down the field, get some points, give them a little bit of a break, because they've been on the field a lot in this third quarter.
Final minute of the third. Hoover in motion, swing it out to him. Oh, and he's upended by Aaron Diggs.
Just
Diggs will hobble off now.
The Leathernecks just swarming on defense. Four Western Illinois players over there to make the tackle. And it's just a nice defense for them. Speedy, fast.
Back inside the 22 now. For Missouri State, second along 13. And moving into the wind, the Bears will just let the clock run out and change ends for the fourth quarter. So headed to the fourth, Western Illinois, a 17-point lead over Missouri State. The Leathernecks lead 31-14 as we go to the fourth quarter in Springfield.
The roll form steel bed of the Chevy Silver.
And Lucy, Corey Riggs, our producer. Great to have you along on KOZL. Bears football, but the Bears down 17 headed to the fourth.
A big third quarter. Western Illinois taking advantage of some of the mistakes that Missouri State has made. They got that partially blocked punt. Didn't return a punt return, got it all the way down to the one. So capitalizing on what's been given them for Western Illinois. Nice play here by Lambert.
Fake to Crowder, caught at the 25, and a flag comes flying in.
That was after Hoover was able to get the first down.
So Hoover as far as the 42, and the flag will be marked back at the 34, 12 yards into the play.
Are they going to have
illegal block in the back? Offense number 39. That penalty's 10 yards from the spot of the foul. Still second down.
So back to the 24. It's a net gain of 2. And it remains second down.
You kind of get that when you've got the... When Hoover made the catch, yeah, see how he changes his direction, and there's the block in the back.
Nick Masoner on the block in the back there.
Almost lost the ball as well as he was running there. All in all, I'll take a 10-yard block in the back than a fumble.
Lambert back. Deep downfield. Stewart! Oh, and it's dropped. Marcus Stewart.
Lambert stayed in the pocket, stood his ground, and then let go with that pass, and it was right on his fingertips just for a couple of seconds, and then he dropped it.
Marcus Stewart. Oh, would love to have that one back. Third and 11. Swung out to Crowder. Oh, and stumbled and fell at the 23, and that'll lose one.
I think you're going to get roughing the passer here, because Western Illinois had three guys back there on a rush, on a blitz. And the flags came in after Lambert hit the ground. So we'll see what happens out of this. That may be a first down for the Bears. Western's Pete Swenson was on a blitz.
Personal foul. Roughing the passer. Defense number 50. That penalty 15 yards from the previous spot. Automatic first down.
Big break.
Boy, a big break that coming off of that dropped pass by LaMarcus Stewart.
So out to the 39-yard line for Missouri State in a first and 10. Lambert looks left, and it's incomplete over the head of Hoover.
And that time he just overthrew Zach Hoover, but... I like the way that it seems to me that there's better rhythm offensively for these guys in this half. I mean, maybe the shock of not having Malik Earl in that first half kind of had him off kilter, but, at least it looks like they got things going just a little bit here.
Two touchdowns, both through the air for the Bears, one to Eric Furmanek, one to Deion Holloman. And now out to the right to the 40-yard line.
I think Willis Chambers was there, and this is the guy that's playing in place of Malik Earl.
To the 42-yard line. Bears trailing 31-14. Early fourth. And Lambert. Caught. And then nearly bent in half.
And that's Willis Chambers again.
Oh, and he's down. Had to hurt the back.
He held on to the ball, though, and he got the first down. And he's up.
Whew.
He's a young kid, you know. When you're young and you're wiry, you can do this. Kind of landed on the defender's hip, too.
Like a cat there. What do you say about cats? Don't have backbones. Shapes they can bend in.
Went up top, got the catch, got the first down, stayed in the game.
Lambert looks deep downfield to Hoover and off his fingers.
That was the second opportunity. Lambert looked toward Holloman on the left wing first and then went downfield. And this is the same kind of thing that happened last week against the Bison, is a couple of passes right into the hands of his receivers and they've been dropped.
Oh. And another one that could have been six.
Right off his helmet. Yeah, right off the front of his helmet. And, you know, I don't know. Are you going from the sun into the shade there? Whatever it is, but that ball hit him right in the helmet.
Here's LaMarcus Stewart. Breaks free. And here he goes. Stewart is going to take it the rest of the way.
There you go.
Touchdown from 49.
Broke two tackles on that one. Able to overcome the ball hitting Zach Hoover's helmet. And then LaMarcus Stewart with a nice catch along the near sideline. Breaks a foot tackle and then gets into the end zone. That's how you get back in this game. He's a senior from Memphis. Check it out. Catch. And then gets out of this right here. Holds onto the ball. A little block. Nice block down there. It looked like maybe by Holloman.
No point in going for two here yet. So the kick is good. And it's 31-21 Western Illinois with 13 minutes to go at Plaster Stadium.
Intercepted, so a pretty good game for Brody Lambert that way. Bears running the ball, and it looked like the offense has a little bit more rhythm here in this second half, and the defense it seems like Western Illinois' last couple of touchdowns have come on some special teams plays, you know, that the one punt that they let go and then the partially blocked punt the other way, that got some points, so Bears right in this.
Just one turnover total today, and that was the first half interception thrown by Lambert as he was hit. Wind is still screaming out of the south. Everything kicked into that end zone today has come out to the 25.
Now, I'll tell you a couple things that Steck likes to look at here. Third downs, the Bears able to convert just 4 of 12. He's not going to be happy about that. Penalties, only 4 for 45, so he'll probably take that. And then just that one turnover. So we'll see what the defense can do.
And Fumble. The ball's loose. as we bring up turnovers. The Leathernecks give one back.
And that is so rare. Western Illinois has came into this game with just one fumble all season long, and the Bears get one right at the right opportunity.
Jared Beshore out with the ball for Missouri State. And this will be at the Leatherneck 22-yard line.
Problem right there with the exchange. And that's, is that McShane? No. That is not McShane running back there for
Devin Moore, 28.
It's been Gilmore and McShane in the backfield for the entire game for Western Illinois, and they put the third guy in there. Exchange problem. Missouri State needs to take advantage of this.
Haven't heard much from Devin Moore. But a bad exchange there, and the Bears have it at the Western Illinois 22.
And I think that was the first time he was in the game for Western Illinois.
I think so.
Yep. And again, I mean, Western Illinois with just one fumble all season long. This is game, what, six?
Right.
Yeah.
A big chance here for Missouri State to the outside, and Phoenix Johnson nowhere to go. Maybe a yard at best.
Leathernecks' David Griffith, defensive back, cobbling off for them.
And Griffith.
Kind of, I mean, you know, you really want to get a touchdown here. You don't want to just settle for a field goal.
A score of any kind would get him within one score at least. Stewart to cross in motion. Lambert back for a lateral. And this is caught by a lineman, eligible, Coleman Clanton, and a flag is down.
Well, now they're gonna throw a flag on this. The question was whether or not that pass was thrown behind the line of scrimmage. They're gonna play out the holding, so you can come back from holding.
Wow.
So I guess it was tackle eligible.
Holding. Offense, number 77. 10-yard penalty from the spot of the foul. Still second down.
Well, that takes off a reception by Coleman Clanton.
I was going to say, it was nice catch by the big man, and then puts it away, 3-point holding it. And it has to come back. You know, you talk about Steck. He's gone, you know, fourth and one. He goes for it. Fake punt returns. He had the one wildcat play earlier in this game, and then you've got that pass. So he's not afraid to pull all the plays out of the playbook.
Second and 18, back at the 30. And deep downfield to Stewart at the 4 for a first and goal.
Hello, LaMarcus Stewart. Welcome to the party. Big second half for him. Another catch. He already has a touchdown here. And he's stepping up in place of Malik Earl. Again, the senior from Memphis, Tennessee.
They overload the left side. Go that way to Zach Hoover. And in for the touchdown.
Missouri State taking advantage of the fumble. Western Illinois gave it to him and then cash it in. And we've got a ball game here with 11:43 left.
Touchdown catch for Zach Hoover. His second of the year.
Four touchdown passes for Brody Lambert so far in this game. Big game for him. And he had his friends up front, right? Zach Hoover's friends up front. He gets the ball. He has three guys blocking in front of him, including LaMarcus Stewart and Deion Holloman. High snap. Got it through.
It is a three-point game, 31-28, with 11:43 to go. Getting good here in Springfield. Stay with us. Bears football on KOZO. Scored two straight touchdowns here in the fourth quarter, and there's still 11:43 left, capitalizing on the fumble and the turnover by the Leathernecks. And it is a three-point game with a long way to go.
Marcus Stewart really stepping up. You know who's the next man up? Who's going to step up for Missouri State with Malik Earl not being in there? LaMarcus Stewart, four catches, 95 yards, and a touchdown. And he had another big catch in that drive for the Bears. And you've got Hoover with a touchdown, Stewart with a touchdown, Furmanek and Holloman. So Brody Lambert spreading it around a little bit. The Bears defense forcing a turnover. Rarity for the Leathernecks. And we got a ball game here.
Ball off of the tee. Wind hasn't let up at all.
Missouri State has beaten this Western Illinois team five straight times in the overall series. They've won three of four against them on homecoming. Can they come from behind and do that in this game? Now, last week against Indiana State, the Sycamores scored 21 third-quarter points to take the lead on Western in the fourth quarter, and then Western was able to come back with a late drive. So they're not going to give up. The Bears aren't giving up, and we're going to have a fist fight here for the next 11 minutes and 43 seconds.
Out to the 25. Set out. Just a field goals difference between these two now.
Wondering if there was an issue with Gilmore or McShane. Remember, they put that one running back in for this, that one play, and there was a fumble on the exchange.
It was Devin Moore.
Devin Moore for Western Illinois, and it looks like McShane is back there now for them. Western Illinois, Steve McShane. He's just a sophomore.
14 carries for 50 yards to lead the ground game for the Leathernecks. Here's a wide open field for McGuire. His pass caught at the 35-yard line. Adam Conrad.
He was looking for Lenore, but Lenore was covered up by...
Let's go down to Megan Rice.
Thanks, guys. Bears senior linebacker Dylan Cole has been that face of the franchise type of player in his time here at Missouri State. He was a captain named and also a preseason All-American pick. He also is coming off of a season-high 15-tackle performance against the top team in the country, North Dakota State, just last week. Now, that's all well and good, but what he does off the field's almost more impressive. He takes part in Fellowship Christian Athletes on campus, and he was also went to a mission trip to the Dominican Republic in April to help orphans. Guys, back to you.
All good stuff there for Megan Rice. Thank you.
It's Western Illinois' 83, Conradi, it looks like, is on the ground there.
Yeah, he got bent backwards there.
And they didn't think he was going to play in this game. And it is his right knee or foot.
And a slow move over to the Western Illinois bench. Adam Conradi. Leathernecks at home to face North Dakota State next Saturday evening at 6 o'clock at Hanson Field in Macomb. Western Illinois at South Dakota in 2 weeks. Home games in November on the 5th against Illinois State, the 12th against Northern Iowa, and at Southern Illinois to close out the regular season November 19th. Western will start at the 36 from here. And it goes to McGuire, or to McShane from McGuire, to the 43.
Yeah, the Bears were coming on a blitz on that side, and then they just beat it by handing it off to McShane. And he kind of just leaned into the crease there on the left side off the tackle, and they took it up for a gain of about 8 right there.
A 7-yard pickup with 11 minutes to go.
Now, Coach Fisher's going to be content to just take this ball and just run it right down the middle of the field, eat clock, and continue to give it to his running backs.
And keeper for McGuire, and he'll have the first down. The 47. Dylan Cole in on another stop. Cole has moved from 10th to 9th in career tackles at Missouri State. He has passed Cornelius Blow from the early 1980s. Needed 4 to pass him and had 7 in the first half. Next target on the career tackles list for him is James Houston, and that's doable today too. Back to McShane into Bears territory to the 48. That's a gain of close to five.
Yeah, and McShane, again, you know, Steck was saying he doesn't have a lot of speed, but he's just got, he kind of just leaned a little bit and got out of the arms of the tackler and then was able to kind of get in there and get a couple more yards.
.9:35, the clock moving. To the right this time. And again, McShane bottled up quickly. A yard or so at best, and Bears will look for a stop on third down.
Big play right here, obviously. And you've got Lenore and Borsellino, the two receivers, walking off the field. McShane's back there now. Timeout by Coach Fisher.
That'll be the first called by either team in the second half.
I mean, we got a third and four, and he's taking his receivers off the field, so interesting.
So 9:02 to go. And Missouri State up, or trailing, 31-28. Go ahead, so much material on Malik Earl today. And then we find out 10 minutes before the game he's not going to play. The next guy he's going to pass on Missouri State's career receiving yards list is, remember Ray Ratcliffe from the late 1980s, 85 to 88? He goes by his given first name now, Lester Ray Ratcliffe. He's a teacher at Reed Middle School, and today was working the concession stand here as a fundraiser for Reed to send their kids to Washington, D.C. over spring break. Lester Ray was a football coach at Parkview for several years, but not in coaching right now, just teaching. He stayed in town. Been a guy we've been privileged to get to know, Lester Ray Ratcliffe.
After the timeout, Western Illinois brought Lanier back on the field along with Borsellino, and it was in his hands and out of his hands. Bears hold. Nice hit there by Missouri State's Darius Daniel. Popped Lenore right when the ball got to his hands. He dropped it. How rare is that? Almost as rare as a leatherneck fumble. And Missouri State will at least force the punt here.
So at the start of the fourth quarter, Missouri State was down by 17. And now 6 minutes later, they're within three and are about to get the ball back.
And they've got the wind with them, and they're down three.
This will be let go, and again, will bounce down inside the five. Great job, again, by the punter, Nathan Knuffman. 8:46 to go, 31-28 Western Illinois. The Bears will drive for a tie or the lead when we come back. Down by three, they're inside their own 1 yard line to start this drive.
Now, right after that last punt, you know, Deion Holloman, one of the leading returners in FCS football, but this is the second time that he's let a punt go over his head, and they've got it on the 1 yard line. And as soon as Holloman came off the field, Steck went right up to him and grabbed him, was yelling at him and talking to him about where he's at on the field, why he's letting those punts go over his head when he should be fielding them. Because, I mean, that one hit about the 10-yard line and then rolled all the way to the one. And there was nobody around him. He should have been able to make that catch.
Lambert deep. There's a little space, but it's incomplete to Hoover. And don't think there's ever been a 99-yard touchdown pass in Bears football history.
Hoover had his defenders beat, but the throw was just a little bit too far leading him. That was a nice throw, though. Good idea. So I'm sure that Holloman, Steck's not happy with the way that Holloman, in fact, he's walking on the sideline with his arm around him right now, continuing to talk to him on the sideline. Actually, that's Hoover.
And this one is incomplete to LaMarcus Stewart. And that quickly, it'll be third and 10 at their own one for Missouri State.
You know, Steck will roll the dice, and you're talking about first and 99.
Yeah.
And the first play you do is you go for a home run. And he didn't get it, but now you're looking at third and 99.
Lambert, the rush on. He'll go to Stewart, and it's intercepted. and a knee down, picked off by David Griffith.
He just overthrew LaMarcus Stewart, it looked like, on that route.
Second interception, second turnover today for Missouri State.
Just threw it again from that angle, not able to see. Here we go. There was a blitz coming up the middle by Swenson. And then, yeah, that was LaMarcus Stewart. Overthrew him by 10 yards. But I bet you he was seeing Swenson coming right down his throat on that blitz.
So at the Missouri State 21-yard line now for Western Illinois with 8:29 left.
Lambert has four touchdown passes, but second interception of the game.
Jamie Gilmore, the running back in the I formation.
One of the keys we had before this game for Western Illinois is take advantage of Missouri State mistakes, and they can do that right here and lock up this game. Jamie Gilmore getting just hauled down. Gilmore's interesting, Don, grad student transfer. So he comes to Western Illinois with just 1 year of eligibility, and Coach Fisher saying that he fits into the system right away when he got in here, and he actually recruited him when Fisher was an assistant coach at Miami of Ohio. He's able to get him now on the tail end of his career. 1 year, and he's really making the most of it this season, and he's making the most of it in this game. 12 carries, two touchdowns, 42 yards.
From the 18, second and 7, the fake to Gilmore, the rollout. McGuire and Lenore is out of bounds. And incomplete anyway.
Yeah, didn't make the catch, but boy, Dylan Cole just hammered McGuire on the tail end of that play, coming in off of a blitz. Another big third down for the Bears defense, so they have another one in them. Because right now, this isn't a gimme. It looks like the wind's blowing even stronger now than it was at the beginning of the game.
Remember, Knuffman's into that wind
right
here in the fourth quarter, kicking. He missed from 40 earlier, going this way. McGuire shakes one man, delivers, and it's out of bounds toward Lenore. So fourth down coming.
Bears very, very lucky on that play right there. Before the snap, Darius Daniel, the cornerback over here on the near side, complete confusion as to what coverage they were going to be in the backfield. He was looking over to the coaches and was putting his hands up, didn't know exactly what he wanted to do, but they were able to hold and force this fourth down decision by Western Illinois.
And they're not going to kick from 35 into this wind. At least not yet.
Line change for Missouri State. Can they get everybody in position before the snap? Lenore coming in motion.
Timeout.
Okay.
So, time to think about it here. Charlie Fisher.
There's a lot on the line.
Boy.
7:34 left in this quarter. But, yeah, that play before, Darius Daniel was the left cornerback, and he was looking over toward the sideline, had his hands up in confusion. What defense do you want us to be in? How do you want us to defend this play? Didn't really get an answer. The ball was snapped, and a little bit of a pass rush there helped out the Bears, and then the pass wasn't on target for McGuire.
Missouri State at Northern Iowa next Saturday, 1 o'clock. At home against Southern Illinois in 2 weeks on October 29th for a 2:04 kick. And two away and one at home in November at South Dakota State, November 5th. At Illinois State, November 12th. And home to close out the regular season, November 19th against Youngstown State.
One thing the Bears have not done this season is suffer back-to-back losses. See if they can hold here and get the ball back. Big fourth down.
Leathernecks need 7. Here we go. McGuire toward the end zone, intercepted.
There's the kid, Cameron Price, true freshman from Missouri State. Picks off the ball on the goal line, and then there's going to be a targeting penalty, I'm sure.
If it is, it may be an ejection.
Because at the end of that play, he just got hammered on the helmet. Dylan Cole, the captain, is standing there right next to the officials where the flag is, and then the linesman's talking with Steck.
There's a bear down, and Cameron Price brings it back to the 25.
And that is Darius Joseph from Missouri State, who's getting up. He looks like he's jumping
Darius
up and down.
Darius Joseph, now. The injured player.
Let's see what we got here, penalty-wise.
There's no foul on the play. Ruling on the field is an interception. First down, Missouri State.
Wow.
How can there be no penalty on that play? All right, let's take a look at this. First of all, there's the pass, the pickoff by Cameron Price. Then he comes out. Watch the end of this play. Tell me if it's not helmet to helmet. And the flag come right in at that point. I guess they just looked at it and said...
Okay. And a slow-mo look at it. Boy, it looks like helmet to helmet to me, Dan.
Either that or whether it wasn't helmet to helmet, but shoulder pad to helmet, that's still targeting. Or they could have said that maybe he was slipping at the end of that play. But anyway, regardless, big stand for the Bears to get an opportunity here. Furmanek again.
First turnover for Western Illinois, and Furmanek out to the 39.
Now, they've got two turnovers. The fumble led to a touchdown, right. And now the interception here. So this is rare for Western Illinois. Bears with 13 turnovers coming into this game for one of the top teams in the Valley and in the nation. 13 turnovers, pick a couple more, 15 now for the Bears.
Less than half a quarter to go, and Missouri State down 3. With the ball, Lambert, rush on. Oh, boy, that's incomplete. Forward pass.
He had a receiver over there. It looked like, that was Crowder over on that side.
Lineman.
It looks like that's Shantz.
Hurt there. Riley Shantz from...
He's the
Glendale High School.
Senior center. The Missouri State's offensive line is very young, and one of the veterans on that is Riley.
His dad, Joe Shantz, goes back far enough that Joe was the head coach of Greenwood when they had football up until the early 90s after Paul Mullins retired.
If I'm not mistaken, there was a certain person that was... that held the snaps for the extra points for Greenwood. That by the name of Payne Stewart, maybe?
Yeah, back in the 70s when Jan Stolle was the kicker for Greenwood. Yeah. Payne Stewart was the holder. It's a great story Jan tells.
I was going to say, he had to be real careful not to mess with those talented hands of Payne Stewart.
Well, he said Payne had let go of the ball a little too soon to make sure he didn't get kicked.
Well, he wasn't dumb.
Their own 39 now for the Bears with Shantz out. And a little step up and go here for Lambert, but only to the 40.
Again, I like that play. Even though, you don't really pick up any yardage, what you do is you keep the Bears or the Western Illinois linebackers honest, because if you never run the ball, then they're not going to, attack. They're going to stay back in the pass route. So little play right there. Third down, third and long here. Bears need a first down badly.
Lambert on third down across the middle to Hoover and caught at the Leatherneck 49.
Very difficult catch because the official was right there and almost kind of was masking him. Let's take a look at this pass. Look where the official is. The striped shirt's right over his shoulder into Zach Hoover's hands, and he got a hit toward his helmet as well at the end. I don't know. I don't want to say Western's taking some shots at the receivers, but... There's a couple of plays where Missouri State's helmets have been rattled around a little bit by some shoulder pads.
Bears have all another catchable ball dropped, have all three of their timeouts left, and Stewart doesn't hang on to this one.
He was wide open, too.
Second and 10, 5:52 left. Stewart's a little shaken up.
Now they've got Jason Randall in there.
Yeah, you liable to snap it right to him.
Exactly.
Uh-oh, Lambert back for it. He'll try to make something of it. And we'll get out of bounds. And might have lost a shoe there. No, maybe a towel.
I mean, he had the ball. He drops the ball on the snap, picks it back up again, able to kind of move the ball out of there. Didn't throw it an interception.
Now he's got the chance to throw it here, but doesn't.
Yeah, the last couple of games when that situation has happened, he's rolled like that, trying to throw the ball. He's dropped it on the ground. A fumble against Indiana State and a fumble against North Dakota State. So this time, I guess, coach just told him to tuck it and run for his life.
Third and 15. The Bears down a field goal. Lambert across and caught at the 35 for Missouri State, Jalen Esters. And it's a first down inside the 20.
Big play by Jalen Esters. Holy smokes. Another receiver heard from here on the Bears.
His first catch of the year.
Big one. Huge.
To the 17 of the Leathernecks.
And how about the yak after that, huh?
Yeah. Yards after catch.
Forcing Western Illinois to call a timeout here. And you've got what? Steck's got three in his pocket still.
And that's the last for Western Illinois.
Charge timeout.
How about this veteran receiver?
Jalen Esters. First catch of the year.
Breaks two tackles. Little Jimmy move there. Three tackles. Hauled down. Nice play.
He is from Port Huron, Michigan, and from Rochester Community Tech.
Rochester Community Tech, huge JUCO football powerhouse there, I guess.
Well, he caught 79 passes last year for 1,245 yards.
Well, big play for him. Nice.
Jalen Esters.
Port Huron, Michigan.
So 17-yard line, first down, 5:02 to go.
Jason Randall still in the backfield for Missouri State.
Of course, they
kept Esther out there, of course, I would.
Give to Randall. And Randall powers it down just shy of the 10. We're under 5 minutes to go. Missouri State driving for a possible lead. The Bears have not led in the game yet. And second and four. Lambert looking, and it is caught
touchdown.
For the touchdown and the lead. Deion Holloman.
I was going to say, Deion Holloman's second touchdown reception of the game. Boy, in the corner of the end zone, catch, and then gets his 1 foot down for the touchdown. Again, take a look. Lambert rolling. Right on line. Fifth touchdown pass of the game for Brody Lambert. Missouri State takes its first lead in this game. Oh, yeah.
Wow.
No doubt.
Second touchdown for Holloman, and now for a 4-point lead. The extra point try coming, and they must be satisfied. I was going to say they may review this, but on we go. Zach Drake. And good. A 21-point fourth quarter for Missouri State. Western Illinois with Zippo. And the Bears have taken a 4-point lead, 35-31 with 4:22 left.
Here's your touchdown pass again. Concentration by Holloman to make the catch and then drag the foot for the touchdown. Huge for Missouri State. And how about Brody Lambert? 5 touchdown passes in this game. Holloman with a couple of touchdown receptions, taking advantage of that drive started. with the interception on the goal line by Cameron Price, and then finishes up 99 yards later. So impressive there for Missouri State. 4:22 left. Lots of time left in this game. Last week at Indiana State, Western Illinois fell behind in the fourth quarter and then came back late to win. Can Missouri State hold them off this week?
Still time left. Ball off the kicking tee.
Brody Lambert, the fourth Missouri State Bear to throw five touchdown passes in a game.
Tie the school record.
Tie the school record.
Missouri State up 35-31. And out to the 25. Wow. You believe this?
It's turnovers will obviously turn the game over, but I mean just the opportunity. Western Illinois in that third quarter when they built their big lead took advantage of Missouri State mistakes and what they were given, and in the fourth quarter the Bears doing the exact same thing, taking advantage of a fumble to score a touchdown and then that interception on the goal line to come back out the other way. There's still work to be done. It's not over yet. 4:22 left for the Bears, but they're on the have the lead on the scoreboard for the first time all day on this homecoming.
Now an empty backfield for McGuire. Steps back and fires. Caught at the 30-yard line by Gilmore. We'll stretch it toward the 35. And a little shy, about a yard and a half short of the first down.
Now Gilmore's that grad transfer running back, but he can catch the ball out of the backfield. It's the fifth time that he's done it this season. So that's another weapon for McGuire along with his other receivers.
So the other Bears to throw five touchdowns in a game, A.J. Porter did it twice in 2003 and Jay Rogers in 1999. Play fake. And to midfield, and that's Lenore into Bears territory.
Trying to get out of bounds to keep the clock, but he was not able to do that.
So they moved the chains at least. And now we'll wind with 3:44 and counting. Western Illinois out of timeouts. The look, short pass, incomplete. And the Bears with Jared Beshore covering.
Blamey was in there on the blitz coming off the edge and disrupted McGuire's pass, but Blamey's had another big game. Back-to-back big games for the kid from Monette, the Cub.
3:24 left. Western to the line at the Missouri State 49, second and 10. Out of the backfield, Gilmore to the 40, 39, and down there.
Looks like he got the first down. First time in this whole game that they've been using Gilmore out of the backfield. He's got 42 yards of running with two touchdowns on the ground, and he's got now 31 yards with a couple of catches.
There's confusion on whether this is a first down, and they're going to move the chains over there. Referee Matt Gallagher over to talk with his linesman.
I guess it's the third down.
Now they say first down and move him. But that spot right on the 39, it had to be. Charlie Fisher looking for a touchdown to win here. A field goal at this point does him no good.
Yeah.
3 minutes to go at Plaster. Back to the air. McGuire going deep. And he can't hook up with Lenore.
Double coverage there from the Bears on Lenore. Now, McGuire, just a sophomore for Western Illinois, and Coach Fisher really poised, likes this, the poise that his quarterback has. And, he's worked with quarterbacks in the past, and that's kind of what his, as an assistant coach, he did. So he kind of likes what McGuire can do, and, boy, he's got a lot of weapons on this team. Borsellino coming out on this side with Lenore, the bottom of the screen.
Had to hurry, and
that play was messed up from the beginning.
I'd say, yeah.
First of all, it looked like somebody on Western jumped. Maybe the left tackle jumped at the very beginning of that play, and then McGuire wanted to hand it off to somebody that wasn't there. Let's take a look. Yeah, we got a jump right there, number 45, whoever that tackle was for them.
Tight end Tyler Slammons.
So no flag.
To get him for grounding here? If it is, it's loss of down.
Intentional grounding.
Yeah.
Offense number 18. Ball placed at the spot of the foul. Loss of down. Fourth down.
Oh, boy.
Intentional grounding, probably because his tight end jumped and got out of the play. Regardless, fourth down, they're gonna have to go for it, and the Bears are going to have to hold at least one more time.
Fourth and 17.
Homecoming comes down to this.
Remember, Western Illinois out of timeout, so if the Bears get the ball back, it wouldn't take much to run out the clock. Maybe one first down.
You've got Isbell on that front line. You've got Blamey that's in there as well. Dylan Cole in the middle linebacker position. All these guys have had big games so far for the Bears.
Okay, so they're going to correct and say third down.
So no loss of down, just the yards.
So third and 17. So two chances here for the Leathernecks to get it as far as the 29, and there's timeout for Missouri State now, 2:52 to go.
Steck had a bunch in his pocket, and he was just wanting to see what kind of a lineup Western Illinois was going to come out in to kind of set his defense. So what happened on that last play, it was third down, and the tight end jumped. No flag there. The play fell apart, and McGuire just kind of dumped it off, and then he got called for illegal grounding, and then they just marched off the penalty and then kept him at third down. So kind of a break for Western Illinois that way. I guess it would have been a loss of down if it was an illegal pass, but since it was just grounding, it's the penalty.
This game is about to hit the 3.5 hour mark.
The Bears aren't going to care if they can come away with the win.
Yeah. Two minutes, 52 seconds left. Missouri State came from 17 down at the start of the fourth quarter to score three unanswered touchdowns here in the fourth and lead 35-31.
All right, you got Lenore on the top of your screen. You got LeShore on the bottom of your screen. He's caught a touchdown already this game.
Deep downfield and caught.
And that's Borsellino.
Wow. Leatherneck still right in it.
And he just went straight down the field on that drive. On that route. That route was just a seam route right down the middle of the field. Nice pass by McGuire. Over the shoulder catch.
Squarely on the 10-yard line for first and goal.
Borsellino, a senior for these Leathernecks. 2,000 yards in his career for the Leathernecks. Five 100-yard receiving games, too.
Western Illinois has to have a touchdown. First and goal and incomplete over the head of Tony Harper.
McGuire's got all of his tools out there. He's got Lenore, LeShore, Borsellino, and then he's got Gilmore coming out of the backfield. So they're throwing at least four receivers into the defensive backfield. And then that tight end makes it five. Try it again.
Complete to Gilmore at the six.
Nice tackle by Darius Joseph from Missouri State to keep him out of the end zone.
Third and goal for Western Illinois.
Look at Joseph close and make the tackle by himself. Keep him out of the end zone.
The Leathernecks have two chances to get it in here for the lead. Or they're going to go back to Macomb with a loss. Down to this. Third and goal. And the run for McGuire. He's down to the one.
He changed that play and audible on it. And it looked like Cole maybe had been in there on the stop. They're going to put the ball on the half-yard line.
Oh, Dan.
Cole with the stop. Yep, kept him out. The ball never crossed the... This is it.
A minute to go. Two timeouts left for Missouri State, none for Western Illinois. Fourth and goal at the one. Here's your ball game. The handoff and the push and in for the touchdown for Western Illinois. And it's Devin Moore who fumbled the exchange earlier.
How about that for Coach Fisher? You put the kid in who dropped the ball earlier in this quarter, and he takes it in for the touchdown. Remember, this kid fumbled the ball to get Missouri State back in this game. Nice hit there by Dylan, right on the line, the goal line, but he was able to power his way in. Another look here. There's the initial contact by Dylan Cole, but the kid keeps pushing his legs. Devin Moore gets in there for the touchdown.
Now there's still 43 seconds left. And no time will run off on this extra point, so there will be that much time for Missouri State. The kick is good, and Western Illinois goes up 38-35. So after the Bears scored three unanswered touchdowns in the fourth quarter, the Leathernecks come back with the play that they had to have on fourth and goal at the one.
Still amazing. You've got McShane and you got Gilmore. They're two running backs that have been playing this whole entire game. And you've got the one kid, Devin Moore, who actually got into the game once and fumbled the ball. Coach gave the ball back to him on fourth in the game.
Yeah.
And he got in for the touchdown. Talk about redemption there. Missouri State's defense just gave all it could. The stop at the goal line, and he got in.
An 11-play, 75-yard drive for Western Illinois to take the lead. 43 seconds left.
Missouri State has one of the best kick returners in FCS back there right now, Deion Holloman.
This will be into the wind, so it should be returnable. Luke Otto to kick it for the Leathernecks.
Steck's got two timeouts left.
Right. They're going to have to hurry. Blake Lock down to one. And it will be from the 17-yard line to Phoenix Johnson. He's to the 23.
It looked like they wanted to do some kind of trick play there with Holloman coming up behind Phoenix Johnson, and they all kind of had gathered around, and that was a play Indiana State did a couple of years ago against the Bears, and it went for a touchdown. But that fizzled out. 38 seconds left. Need to get within field goal range.
The Bears need about 40 yards to get there. Remember last week, Zach Drake made good from 50 against North Dakota State for the Bears' only points.
He's got a tailwind this time.
Lambert to Stewart, and incomplete.
That one was just overthrown.
And Stewart is still down at the Bears' nose at midfield.
A lot of guys have cramped up in this game. Really hot today, 80-something degrees.
Again, our thanks to Andy Bees for sponsoring Missouri State Bears football today. Daniel Shedd for his work on the Bear Up pregame show. Megan Rice on the sidelines.
Been an exciting game. Big comeback for the Missouri State Bears, and all the way down to the last seconds of regulation. And it's not over yet. The Bears with some opportunities here. They're still taking a look at LaMarcus Stewart. Mm-hmm.
Our producer is Corey Riggs. Our crew here on hand for a 3.5 hour plus game and still counting. Stewart.
It looks like his left ankle may be kind of banged up a little. He's kind of hobbling off the field, but giving the Bears an opportunity to kind of talk over what they want to do. Second down. At least try to get 40 yards, 35 yards to get in some kind of position. He does have a tailwind, but...
Well, they're 40 yards away from a 50-yard field goal try.
Right.
33 seconds. Lambert up for grabs, intercepted, and that's going to do it. Xavier Rowe with the pick.
Yeah, Jalen Esters was running that route, and he just stopped the route about halfway through it, kind of broke off thinking that maybe he was going to try to help Lambert, but Lambert went with what the original route was going to be for him. Here's another look. You can see he just stops right there, 81.
And so Western Illinois with the ball, 26 seconds left. Yes, Missouri State has two timeouts remaining, but at this point they're not going to do any good. The Leathernecks will come out in victory formation. Well, the Leathernecks withstood a punch from Missouri State in the fourth quarter. Three straight touchdowns to go from 17 down to 4 ahead.
The Bears, he did use a timeout.
Stacked the timeout with 21 seconds. Going to do all he can here.
The one thing that I can almost guarantee you, because he told us this about four times after the North Dakota State game, is that there is no such thing as a moral victory as far as he's concerned. This team came back in this game. Here's another look at that last play. You can see right there, Esters looked like he was supposed to go there, and there was a pass rush there as well, but it looked like he broke off his route. Maybe sensing that, maybe come back a little bit, but regardless of that, there's the pick. Sure, he's had a couple of interceptions. However, five touchdowns for Brody Lambert and a big game for him. And the Bears, a big game. I mean, they come back in this game and they took the lead late against the 12th ranked team in the country. This again is Valley Conference football, the top conference in FCS. I mean, if you want to look at it, it's like the SEC.
Final timeout for Steck. So he is out of timeouts, and with 20 seconds left, that's going to be the final chance for Missouri State to stop the clock, and Western Illinois did what it needed to do very late.
Last week they did the exact same thing. Last week on fourth down, it was Western Illinois' defense that made a stop on the Sycamores. This time, late in the game, 40-something seconds left in the game, on fourth down, they get the ball, and again, you give it to the Devin Moore, the player that dropped the ball on the ground and kind of ignited the Missouri State comeback. You show some confidence in that kid, and he puts it in for the touchdown. So this is a tough Western Illinois team. They win against Missouri State for the first time in five tries. This is Bears came in on a five-game winning streak on the all-time series. But again, Steck's going to tell you there's no moral victories. There's a lot of things that need to be cleaned up from this team, but A nice comeback for Missouri State, but just not enough to get the win.
So for the first time since 2008, Western Illinois defeats Missouri State. The final score 38-35. Leathernecks now 5-1, 2-1 in the conference. Missouri State now 3-3.